threats at the tailback position. He's like a CJ Spiller from Clemson. He's like a Javid Best from California. He has more runs over 50 yards than any back in the country. Boise State only gave up one game, one 100-yard rusher the entire season. Ryan Matthews ran for 234 yards against Boise State.
And as a team, one of the best rushing teams in the nation, almost 232 yards per game on the ground for Fresno State. On the other side, you've got Wyoming, a new coach, a new system, a new quarterback, and now new results here in 2009.
Well, of course, the head coach, Dave Christensen, he comes in from Missouri underneath Gary Pinkel, the spread offense. He did such a great job with Chase Daniel at quarterback. Didn't quite have the personnel here, but I think he has a true freshman quarterback in Austin Carter Samuels, who can take this team into the next two or three years with success. Whenever this team has had problems, whenever they've struggled this year, he seems to bail them out with a big run, a big play down the field. Curtis Samuels really has to have a flawless game this afternoon if Wyoming hopes to spring the upset.
And Wyoming coming in at 6-6, 4-4 in the Mountain West this year. Dave Christensen in his first year after being the offensive coordinator and doing great things, as you said, at Missouri. They're in their first bowl game since 2004, so it's been a while, and none of the players has played in a bowl game, so it's a new experience for the Cowboys of Wyoming. Pat Hill, you know all about him. Contract extension, they'll talk about that and work out the details after the bowl season, but in his 13th year, and he's taken the Fresno State Bulldogs to 10 bowl games now in the last 11 years. Fresno State 8-4 overall, 6-2 in the WAC this year, finishing up just behind Boise State and Nevada. Wyoming won the toss, and they elect to receive. Marcel Gibson drops it 3 yards deep, and they'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. So we'll see what the young freshman quarterback can do for the Cowboys. Austin Carter Samuels from Bellarmine Prep in San Jose grew up there, went to camps there, and that's how really they found out about him in Wyoming. Marcus Arroyo was a coordinator at San Jose State, had him at camp, and he's brought him here to Wyoming, to Laramie. So first and 10 from the 20, and Curtis Samuels, who is the Mountain West Freshman of the Year, operating out of the shotgun. The spread offense, another new aspect of this season so far. Alvester Alexander ahead for a short gain of about two on first down. And they'll have to establish a ground game with Alexander and Brandon Stewart, the Wyoming offense. And Alexander, their leading rusher, just over 500 yards on the ground this year. David Leonard, leading receiver and the favorite target of Curtis Samuels. So it's 2nd and 8 from the 22. Quick throw behind the line of scrimmage. That ball's dropped, and that's close. It's incomplete. That was close to a lateral. Alexander, the intended receiver.
Yeah, and you have to be careful on that play. I mean, that's a backward pass, even though the play's blown dead. That's a reviewable play, especially if Fresno State covers it clearly. And I'm not a big fan of throwing the ball laterally in the backfield and taking chances for short games.
So it brings up 3rd and 8 for the Cowboys, who had to win that last game against Colorado State, and they barely did it by a point just to become bowl eligible and earn a trip here to the New Mexico Bowl. 3rd and 8. Curtis Samuels can run it. He's got a lot of ground, too. First down and more, sliding out to the 40-yard line. 1st and 10 Cowboys after the pickup of 18 yards.
And this gives you a look at the mobility and, you know, the feet of Curtis Samuels. And he's been exceptional when this team has needed big plays, and a nice job of slipping Carter, the number one pass rush specialist for Fresno State, and picking up a big gain.
Curtis Samuels, the third leading rusher this year for Wyoming. 1st and 10, they place it down at the 40. They're going to run it this way, trying to get around the edge and get a block. Out close to another first down is Alvester Alexander, the true freshman from Houston. And when Wyoming has the football, David, check out our impact players.
Alvester Alexander, a true freshman, and he's really the playmaker at tailback. He shares time in the backfield with Brandon Stewart, converted wide receiver. And then you got David Leonard, the playmaker outside. Big target, very good after the catch. Chris Carter, the most talented pass rusher on this Fresno State defense.
Brandon Stewart in now as flags come down. Curtis Samuels flips it out to him, and he slips for a loss of about three. But we'll check out the flags as well. You got a Mac crew. Mike Conlin, the referee this afternoon.
Offsides. Number 43 on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
And so a break as we get the first penalty of the game. It goes against Fresno State. Wyoming comes in, David, averaging about 17 points. They'll have to do better than that, you would imagine, today.
Chris Carter has started this football game very aggressively. And he's a load for an offensive tackle to handle. Fresno State has been weak against the run throughout the season, but they do have some ability when you drop back in the pocket.
Tight end Greg Genho in motion. The quick throw again. This time it's complete. Inside the 40 and close to another first down. Zach Bolger, the junior from Casper, Wyoming, on the catch.
We talked at the top about Wyoming and not really having the potency on offense. The recruiting and work, getting some red shirts back into the picture for Dave Christensen next year is going to really upgrade the talent outside. But this is a team that has to hit some short balls and dink and dunk you to move the ball and move the chains.
Second and one, so just shy of a first down. Curtis Samuels caught behind the line of scrimmage and dumped by Logan Harrell, the sophomore from Santa Margarita, California, in a loss of three.
This defensive front for Fresno State is a bit undersized, and they do a lot of moving before the snap. They utilize some movement after the snap. There's some athleticism up front. The Bulldogs have had some trouble when teams have lined up and run the ball at them, and they've also had some trouble against option teams, spread option teams like this Wyoming attack.
Yeah, it's a defense built around speed, not size. East and west, they've been good at. North and south, they've struggled a bit. Curtis Samuels throws and throws it away. Now you're moving this way, you're going to be looking back right into the sun at this point. And it brings up fourth down.
Yeah, this is an interesting spot in the field, especially in a bowl game. I mean, this is the last game of the season, and you get fourth and two, fourth and three in this sector of the field. It's a decision for the head coach. Dave Christensen's going to opt to punt the ball away.
So Austin McCoy, the sophomore from Winter Haven, Florida, is on for the punt. Marlon Moore, one of three men back deep for Fresno State. Almost got there. And this could be a good one. Down to inside the five and close to the one. 41 yards on the punt, and it's downed deep in Fresno State territory. So the Bulldogs will take over from just outside their one early on here in the fourth edition of the New Mexico Bowl from Albuquerque.
Are you ready for the max? Are you ready for the max?
We're always ready for the max.
Yes! I'm ready for the max.
Take your car to the max with quality Conoco gasoline. It's specially formulated to help clean fuel injectors in just five tanks to help reduce emissions and maximize mileage.
Are you ready for the max?
Are you ready for the max?
Help maximize your mileage with Conoco. Take it to the max.
Holy moly! What just happened?
Whoa! I mean, wow, hey, that looks great. And there's no need to discuss it further. In fact, you can buff most of that out. Just give it a once-over with a wet paper towel. Okay, good talking to you.
Accidents are bad, but Geico's good with 24-hour claim service.
Itchy dry scalp? Could be your shampoo. Now there's a new Selsun Blue just for itchy dry scalp. Strong itch fighters target the source of scalp itch, while five moisturizers keep hair healthy.
No more itch.
New Selsun Blue Itchy Dry Scalp.
Got a clue? Get the blue.
Eat chicken wings, buy Hooters things. Christmas is near. Shop, have a beer. Christmas shopping shouldn't be hard.
Simply buy a Hooters gift card. Eat chicken wings, buy Hooters things, shop where in school, right from your stool. Magazines, calendars, great caps. Gifts so cool they will not need wraps. Eat chicken wings, buy Hooters things, Christmas is near, your friends are here. Get yourself to Hooters right now to buy the gifts for those you want to wow. Hooters gifts are always favored.
Hello, I'm New Mexico Governor Bill Richardson. Our state is a proud sponsor of the New Mexico Bowl and welcomes the teams, the fans, and the television audience to the land of enchantment. In addition to offering some great football, the New Mexico Bowl is a chance for us to share some of our hospitality and to showcase some of our state's legendary beauty, cultures, food, and natural wonders. Learn more about us by visiting newmexico.org. Good luck to both teams. And again, welcome to New Mexico.
Missed almost two games with a concussion. Ryan Matthews going to work on offense. Tough place to start this game offensively for Fresno State. From the one, first and 10. Ryan Colburn, the junior quarterback, is going to throw it out to this side. Get a little bit of room. And out to the 10. Quick throw, big game. And close to a first down. Colburn, the junior, who had a tough start to the season, David, 7 interceptions in his first 4 games, but just 4 interceptions since.
Well, and part of that is you're lining up and you're playing Boise State, you're playing Wisconsin, you have a game against Cincinnati, and the 4 losses this season for Fresno State, Colburn had multiple turnovers in all 4 games, but he has been exceptional in the last 8.
Second and 1 from the shotgun down. Left-hander slings it out. And Jamel Hamler with the catch. That's a first down. Hamler, the guy who had the big catch in what was just an incredible finish against Illinois in the final game. And it won 53-52 and went for 2, down by 1 with 2 seconds left on the clock, and made it. Sayi is your 2-2. Their leading receiver, a senior from El Dorado Hills, California. Good offensive line, which has led the way, averaging over 230 yards on the ground this year per game. First down at the 16. Colburn with time dumps it over the middle. Marlon Moore the catch, and he's close, just shy of another first down perhaps. And Moore, biggest average on the team, almost 22 yards per catch.
Well, I like the play calling off the top for Fresno State. You got a Wyoming defense loading up to stop Ryan Matthews, and what a luxury for Ryan Colburn and this experienced, talented wide receiver group. And they're facing a lot of man-to-man coverage outside. And Jeff Grady, the offensive coordinator for Fresno State in the pass game, he's not afraid to take some shots down the field.
Ryan Matthews gets a breather. It's Robbie Rouse in at tailback. Here he comes, looking for a hole. Burst through, got stopped initially, but the second effort before he's taken down by Brian Hendricks. Check out our impact players. When Fresno State has the football and you start, don't end with, but you start with Ryan Matthews.
Yeah, he is a rare combination of tough running between the tackles. He takes the edge almost at will, and he gets into the second and third level, and no one's going to run him down from behind. Shea Ejira Tutu, a very tough wide receiver, but also capable of making the plays down the field. Top 10 in school history as a wide receiver. And then John Fletcher, sack specialist, number one player for Wyoming up front when it comes to making plays behind the line of scrimmage.
A penalty on that last play, a dead ball personal foul, so they'll back Fresno State up and place it down at the 14. Pat Hill back in this bowl game for the second straight year. They played here last year, lost to Colorado State. They were up in that game in the fourth quarter and then allowed Colorado State not to take the lead and win it. Colburn flushed out of the pocket and run out inside the 15. Mitch Unrein, the senior from Colorado, on the pressure. Pretty good up front, this Wyoming defense, that 3-4 look.
Yeah, Wyoming has been fairly solid throughout the season against the run. There have been a couple games where they've been rolled up a bit. Air Force, TCU, but this has been a pretty good front seven in terms of stopping the run. They'll have to be at their best this afternoon against Fresno State.
So it's second and 11. And Colburn under center this time. Going to keep it on the ground. Matthews bringing people with him as he gets across the 15 out to the 17. He's going to get to the 24 for the first down, though. Tashawn Gibson in on the stop. He and his brother Marcel at the corners today. Fletcher, Givens, and Unrein pretty good up front. And Hendricks, leading tackler at that inside linebacker spot. And he'll have to have a big game today. You look at trying to slow down Ryan Matthews. Hendricks will have to play large, and Chris Przinski, who leads him in tackles from that secondary, will have to have a big game. Third and five. Matthews split out, an empty backfield. No pressure, quick throw. Here is Matthews. He dropped it. Might not have gone anywhere anyway. Weston Johnson was there.
Now, this is a great read by Johnson. He's going to read the pass outside wide receiver screen right on the snap of the football, and that's what you have to do on the quick passing game to the wide receivers. Fresno State likes to go down the football field, but they also like to take advantage of the running ability of their wide receiver core. Nice job by Wyoming to turn the ball over.
David Leonard back at his own 38. Robert Malone, first team all-WAC punter on, and this is a good one. Going to send Leonard back to his own 28. And run out of bounds up at the 33. Pretty good defensive stop. Some spirit now for Wyoming as they get a chance on offense. 55-yard punt.
Beenchanted. NewMexico.org.
A bad cold hits your whole body. Alka-Seltzer Plus is specially formulated with powerful cold-fighting ingredients and a strong pain reliever to rush relief everywhere you need it. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
S stands for straightforward, as in upfront, honest, total transparency. Straightforward is the way TD Ameritrade does business. Simple, fair pricing, no hidden account fees, no shenanigans. Just good value, real help. Smart people who are easy to work with. That's what TD Ameritrade stands for. What does your investment firm stand for?
It's time for fresh thinking. It's time for TD Ameritrade.
No matter what goes down, recovery will fix you up. And get a fix on the hangover. Buy it on Blu-ray and DVD.
Has the world gone mad? Jeans that cost $100, $75, $50. Jeans should fit comfortably and look good. New Lee Relaxed Fit are the best fitting, most comfortable jeans, guaranteed. Relaxed price, relaxed fit. Lee, get what fits.
Doc, none of us can remember anything from last night. Remember?
Buy the biggest comedy ever.
Where is Doug?
I am Doug.
His name's Doug, too. Classic mix-up.
What is going on?
The Hangover Unrated. Buy it on Blu-ray and DVD.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
ESPN College Football, the New Mexico Bowl, is brought to you by the New Mexico Tourism Department. Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
Ah, did you know Albuquerque is home to the National Institute of Flamenco Dancing, and they hold the largest flamenco festival in North America. What'd you finish, third in that last year, Nori? Fourth. Excuse me. I'm sorry.
I'm working on my moves. I'm planning on next year.
That guy had your outfit there watching this one. First and 10 from the 32 for Wyoming. Curtis Samuels hands it off to Alexander, who breaks through. Clear running. Trying to get to the end zone. He's going to make it. Touchdown, Wyoming. 68 yards. Got to the secondary, David, and no one was going to catch him.
Well, if there's a player on this offense that's going to hit it with speed, it's Alvester Alexander. And let's look at the cut right here. The lane opens up. He plants the right foot and takes it. Fresno State has had trouble all year long defending the run, especially in offenses like this, Terry, where there's responsibilities. You got to take the quarterback. There's the running back and the zone read, the pitch back, 641 yards. Actually, check that, 461 yards Nevada had on the ground against Fresno State. They've been very vulnerable against potent run games.
And watch the lane in which he had to run. Quick cut, and it opens up. Cornell Banks had a chance, then no one had a chance.
Yeah, not very good angles by the secondary for Fresno State. You know, these safeties, a couple all-conference performers, typically take good angles. But you can't fall asleep on Alexander. He's the one player offensively where if he gets some space, he's labeled to take it to the painted area.
Yeah, you come into this game, too, and a number of people talking about the fact that it might be all Fresno State. Wyoming might need to get some breaks to stay in this, to stay with Pat Hill's club. They got a bit of a break. The penalty, the personal foul on the last series for Fresno State, but then they make the stop on that first set of downs, or the first series at least, to get the ball back, and they're up 7-0 just like that.
Well, I think you need those types of things to slow Fresno State down on offense. You need Fresno State to commit some penalties like the personal foul. You need them to have a sloppy day handling the football. You got to beat them in the special teams. And you know, Pat Hill's team at Fresno State, they've been pretty darn good when it comes to turnovers and special teams over the years.
Jake Scott with the kick. And A.J. Jefferson takes it at his own 7. Dangerous return man. Good return. Across the 30. And out to the 32-yard line. So he brought it back 24 yards. Just kicking it off here. First of 34 bowls in all. Arnell Carrier's New Orleans Bowl coming up. Southern Miss just down the road from Hattiesburg, Middle Tennessee. Tomorrow, 8:30 Eastern time. So the Golden Eagles and the Blue Raiders, Mr. Norrie.
Just a great time of the year. I mean, I'm excited. I can't wait to occupy the couch. I'm going to invite you over, Terry, for a couple of these games.
All right. It would be a first. I'll be there.
We get to head to Hawaii on Monday. I know you're looking forward to that.
Yeah, SMU, Nevada, Sheridan Hawaii Bowl coming up. Play action. Holbrook with time. Throws. Man wide open. Inside Wyoming territory. And a first down. Chasten West, the senior from Moore Park, California. And a 25-yard gain.
And not a lot of quarterbacks across the country have this luxury. The play action fake when Colburn drops back on obvious rundowns, first and second down situations. You know, he's going to have wide receivers open down the field. Wyoming's, you know, they're getting a lot of players up near the line of scrimmage. They don't want to see Matthews just dominate this game from his tailback position. And Colburn's going to get a lot of opportunities as a result.
Lanye Miller, the tailback, now in for Matthews. Straight ahead. And another first down. So the pass play and then the running play in two first downs for Fresno State. Miller, a guy who last year ran for over 800 yards. Now the backup full time to Matthews.
Yeah, Miller went over 100 yards in this very game a year ago in the New Mexico Bowl. And, you know, he is a feature back, a back that would start for a lot of teams on the West Coast. And then you bring in Rouse, a very talented freshman.
Miller with over 2,000 yards in his career. Matthews back in. He's going to get the call. Straight ahead. Squirts inside the 25 to the 24. You know, it's one of the impressive things about him. You think you've got him stopped. You think the progress is done, and somehow he gets through.
No, he is a back that I'm sure has already captured the attention of a lot of GMs at the NFL level, but for those that haven't studied him closely, I think it just gets better and better for this guy. He's got the great combination of every down play from the tailback position on Sundays, and then he's got the explosiveness to be a home run hitter.
5'11", 220, and just a junior, so he's got to make that decision. Does he leave early or stay? Legs driving, finally brought down inside the 20, and they'll move the chains again for Fresno State. A gain of 6. From Matthews.
Yeah, Ryan Matthews has a great offensive line working in front of him, and that's a big part of it. People tend to forget about the offensive line when you see the gaudy numbers, 1,600 plus yards, all the 100 plus yard games. And you know, this offensive line is a line that can dominate a football game. They can soften you, and then in the second half, they rip off big chunks when they're in rhythm.
Matthews out, a little banged up as he headed to the sideline. Robbie Rouse, the true freshman from San Diego, now in at tailback. Holbrook tucks it. He can run it if he wants. Hit hard, spins, still up. Finally brought down at the 9. A gain of 9.
Well, this is a pretty little play by Colburn. Mitch Unrein, number 98, is going to come free, and he gets frozen by a little arm fake. Colburn, not the prettiest runner of the football from the quarterback position, but he's been effective. He had a couple big runs in that Illinois game, and he made some plays late in that game. Terry, you already talked about the one-point win at Illinois.
Still shaking your head at that one, yeah, wondering poor, how they won.
Poor Ron Zook. Somebody needs to send him a letter of apology.
Miller, the tailback. Bernard Camp, the fullback. He lost the football. It's in the pile. They'll scramble and sort it out, and we'll see who came up with it. It's Wyoming football. The Cowboys come up with a big play defensively. Weston Johnson, the man who recovered the football.
Yeah, this is sloppy mesh between tailback and quarterback. And Lanye Miller might have been a bit wide. Colburn might have been a bit shallow coming out, but that is sloppy work on the exchange in the backfield. And you'd think in game number 13, they would have that down. Part of the danger of bringing in a backup back down in the red zone.
And Wyoming takes over when we come back.
ESPN Monday Night Football, Giants Redskins at 8:30.
This holiday, experience the world of Polo Ralph Lauren fragrances. The passion, the tradition, the world of Polo Ralph Lauren fragrances. Holiday gift collection at Macy's.
For a limited time, you can carry out a large Domino's pizza with extra cheese and one topping for just $5.99. But there is one stipulation. Limit 256 per day. That is not happening.
For a limited time, carry out a large one-topping pizza with extra cheese for just $5.99.
Right in the front.
That's like winning the lottery, dude.
Really?
I got that spot once.
Morning, you say.
Hey, guys.
Hey. And the guy was about to go in, right? So I sort of duck under him, right. You know? Man, he pops out of the car. His chili is running so hot. Right? I'm like, dude, it's a parking spot. Relax, right? It's one big deal. Slow day, huh?
A little.
Man, I would kill for that schedule.
Me too, man. I'm telling you, me too.
Hi, Jimmy Football here. Do you ever have trouble putting on a condiment? I know I do. Introducing the Bud Light 3-in-1 condiment gun. Ketchup, mustard, relish, all at once. What?
I hate fumbling around for condiments.
Thanks, Bud Light.
Awesome.
Because it's
tailgate
approved.
Want to get strong? Want to get lean? Want to get ripped? Well, now you can with Iron Gym. Its unique design wraps around your door frame and uses leverage so there's no damage to your door. Do chin-ups and pull-ups in 3 different grip positions. Narrow grip, wide grip, and neutral to strengthen your shoulders, arms, back, and lats. In just minutes a day, you'll build lean muscle and get ripped. Millions of Iron Gyms have sold, and now it's available in stores everywhere.
First the fumble, and now another negative image for Fresno State. Ryan Matthews headed toward the locker room. This is the play on which he injured that leg.
Came on the second effort. Tremendous lower body strain. Didn't look like he was going to stay in the locker room for long. Looked like he was walking pretty well on that foot.
First down carry from the 8. Brandon Stewart, a sophomore from Evansville, Indiana, in a short game.
For Fresno State, you know, sometimes the back will tweak an ankle and they'll go in and they'll get it re-wrapped, but it looked like he was walking fairly well as he headed up the ramp.
Second down play. Here comes Stewart the other way. Trying to get around the edge. Does, but not for much. Just outside the 10. So Stewart and Alexander splitting time at that tailback spot. Brings up third down for Wyoming. Now, this is a team that averaged just under 17 points per game. A lot of optimism in Laramie with Dave Christensen coming in, putting in this spread and all the wonderful things that happen at Missouri, but it hasn't quite gotten there yet. They've been shut out three times. There are five games in which they didn't have an offensive touchdown this year. But a much better record. They're 4-8 a year ago, just 1-7 in the Mountain West. Carter Samuels steps up, picks up a first down across the 20 to the 22 and a gain of 9. Another example of what he can do with his feet.
And I love the play call. Marcus Arroyo, offensive coordinator for Wyoming. You know, this is not a situation where Wyoming is typically comfortable, 3rd and 6, 3rd and 7. You know, they're inside their own 15-yard line. A nice, safe play call. Let Carter Samuels get you out of trouble with his legs.
So it's 1st and 10 from the 21. Stewart, short gain of maybe 1. That's it. Cornell Banks, the junior from Fresno, that nose guard on the stop.
For Fresno State on defense, really, you know, the keys are to put Carter Samuels in obvious pass situation. 2nd and long, 3rd and long. The college game is about first down yardage, and they want to put Samuels in the pocket, not able to threaten this defense with his legs.
Out of the gun, quick throw. This one complete. Bolger the catch. But wrapped up right away. Moses Harris, the strong safety on the stop. He had help. But Harris, not only a second team all-WAC performer, but one of the finalists for the Campbell Award. He was in New York City. An academic Heisman, if you will. And did an internship last year in Hong Kong and got $18,000 to continue his education at Fresno State. Brings up 3rd and 9 for Wyoming. Long count. Carter Samuels nowhere to run. Dumped at the 15. Chris Carter wrapped him up there. Loss of 7. Carter, the junior from Fontana, California.
Well, and Carter beats two players on the top of the screen. He's got a great combination of speed. He can beat you off the edge with a speed rush. And on that play, he just split blockers. And I don't think Carter Samuels felt him from behind in the pocket. That's a tremendous play by Carter.
Not a team normally that's going to put a lot of pressure on a quarterback. But if it's going to come, it's going to come from Carter for the most part. Rugby-style punt this time and a short one. Not a great punt. Taken at the 49 of Fresno State. Pretty good field position after the punt of just 36 yards. Gives us a chance to remind you, L.A. fans, coming this Monday, ESPNLosAngeles.com, your destination for the latest on the teams and players you care most about, USC, the Lakers, Dodgers, Angels, much more. Special L.A. Sports Center, plus news, opinion, and all the inside info, ESPNLosAngeles.com. You'll be checking that one out.
Yeah, well, we were wondering where they'd bring that out to Los Angeles, and look who's coming back. The 21.
So Matthews back to the sideline from the locker room, as expected. Lobby Rouse, the tailback right now. Quick throw, complete. Hamler the catch, close to a first down. Boy, they got, you mentioned it, some dangerous wide receivers. Matthews the calling card for them, but Jamel Hamler, his second catch already this afternoon.
Well, and really you need to have some blocking from your wide receivers outside. Watch the work between the two wide receivers. Now Colbert's going to come up, he's going to get the ball outside, and then Ajira Tutu just cuts the cornerback down, creates some room up the sideline. 2nd and 1.
They operate out of the eye. Ryan Matthews back in at tailback. Going to throw it, though. This one complete to the near sideline and a first down, short gain. Good tackle to Sean Gibson. the sophomore from Dallas on the stop, but Devin Wiley the catch, and they will move the chains.
Now we've seen this more and more in college football, and we're starting to see it a lot on Sundays. Quarterbacks just raising up and getting the ball outside to wide receivers, oftentimes to multiple wide receiver sides, and then letting athletes pick up yards after the catch. Coaches have become more comfortable with quarterbacks throwing that ball outside and not getting into trouble.
And they will not get this play off. As we just heard, it is the end of the first quarter here, the fourth annual New Mexico Bowl from Albuquerque.
Rose Bowl game, Ohio State, Oregon, New Year's Day on ABC.
I love Wii Fit Plus. It has customizable workouts, 6 new exercises, 12 new balance games. Rhythm Kung Fu is my absolute favorite game. You do a right punch, lift your leg up, do a big group high. Yeah! On Bird's Eye Bullseye, you're like flapping your arms. You have to try the obstacle course. You can run really fast. Oh, wait, balance! When you're done with one of the games, you have worked out. If you already own Wii Fit, upgrade to Wii Fit Plus for only $20. It is so much fun to not only play, but watch. Graded E for everyone.
Itchy dry scalp? Could be your shampoo. Now there's a new Selsun Blue just for itchy dry scalp. Strong itch fighters target the source of scalp itch, while 5 moisturizers keep hair healthy.
No more itch.
New Selsun Blue Itchy Dry Scalp.
Got a clue? Get the blue.
McDonald's Big Mac Avatar Thrill Card brings you more. Take your card to McDonald's.com/avatar and see a world like no other with a taste like no other. McDonald's Big Mac. It's that amazing.
What's a 13-letter phrase for marriage proposal?
I have absolutely no idea.
He went to Jared.
He went to Jared.
If you want to create your own one-of-a-kind ring, get to Jared this weekend. Because this weekend, you can receive Get Set in Diamonds rewards. Up to $1,000 toward a beautiful diamond setting when you buy your diamond at Jared. Choose from thousands of diamonds and hundreds of settings. Get up to $1,000 reward this weekend at Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
If you ever make international calls, only Vonage gives you unlimited calling in the U.S. and around the world for just $24.99. Introducing Vonage World. Call 877-4-VONAGE today. Then call India, all of India, or Brazil, all of Brazil. In fact, call all corners of over 60 countries free. And now, sign up by December 31st and get 1 month free. Don't wait. Call 877-4-VONAGE or go to Vonage.com and start saving.
Hey, Ham, what do you think the fine is for streaking?
Oh, I don't know, like $300-$400?
Why?
Go stink!
Sorry. The more you save on insurance, the more you'll have for football. Are you in good hands?
Lady, get out!
Hey, lady. This is no time to play. I'm picking a photo for my Capital One credit card. Old man Sutter? Why would I put his picture on my card? Nice drawing, but this photo's cuter.
Personalize your card by uploading your own photo at CapitalOne.com.
Lady, what's in your wallet?
911, what's your emergency?
Yeah, good look at the Sandia Mountain Range to the east of Albuquerque. The Rio Grande runs through it.
Some beautiful vistas. And look who we have here.
Yeah, Santa here to kick off the bowl season. And at the New Mexico Bowl. With an upset brewing at least right now. 7-0 Wyoming. As Fresno State has it first and 10. They run out of the eye, keep it on the ground, and a gain of maybe 2. So far, David, it's been pretty good defense by Wyoming. You know, the personal foul call against Fresno State to stop their first drive, but then they caused the fumble deep in their own territory on that second to turn it over.
Yeah, you're going to need some help, and sometimes help from Fresno State themselves on offense to slow this machine down. And, you know, what Wyoming's been doing is they've been playing extra defenders on the line of scrimmage, but they're playing soft behind it, and they're going to force Colburn to hit throws in the short zones and move the chains and put together long drives.
if they're going to score. Just a gain of one on first down, so it's second and nine. Matthews can't get out of the grasp. He's going to lose one, perhaps. Josh Bazoon's got there first as we check in quickly in the studio right now with Chris Fowler. Chris?
Oh, Terry, the Stag Bowl, the D3 championship game delayed by a blizzard up and down the East Coast. This is in Salem, Virginia, where Mount Union and Wisconsin Whitewater are colliding for the fifth consecutive year. Mount Union a 29-game winning streak, but Whitewater jumps up on top here 14-7. Jeff Donovan to Corey Robertson, now 21-7 with Mount Union on the doorstep. We'll keep it posted, guys.
Yeah, I do feel for the people back east. It has been quite a day. Much different scene here in Albuquerque. A little chilly, maybe low 40s, but it's not bad at all. Colbert, room to run, and then hit hard at the 33. About 3 yards shy of a first down.
Yeah, this will be an interesting decision for Pat Hill. About a 50-yard field goal coming up. And how about that FCS game last night? Formerly Division I AA, but Montana and Villanova. Congratulations to Villanova. What a well-played game. Tell you what, Caesar, the wide receiver, he's a heck of a player. And Bobby Houck in Montana. A heartbreak there. Third game with Bobby Houck in Montana. Have lost in the title game, but what a great season they had. And Bobby Houck, a big candidate for that UNLV job.
And here it's fourth and three. They're going to go for it. Matthews breaking through. Still up inside the 10, brought down at the 3. Chris Krasinski ran him down there, but Matthews almost broke it all the way. A gain of 30 on a fourth down play.
Well, you have a fourth down, and I like the call by Pat Hill. It's aggressive, it's a bowl game, you don't have much to lose, and great work up front. Nice block by Andrew Jackson, really the most talented offensive lineman on the team, and you can see how Matthews steps through tackle.
First and goal from the 4. Matthews into the air, into the end zone, touchdown. Got a good block from Bernard Camp, the fullback.
Yeah, Bernard Camp, he is a guy that can line up. Bernard Camp can line up, and he is more like an offensive guard at the fullback position. 5'11", 270, clearing the way for Matthews.
Kevin Gessling, the sophomore, on for the extra point. Had a terrific year. This one up and good. So we are tied at 7 here in the second quarter. Checking again with Chris in the studio.
All right, Terry, David, thank you. Time now for a bowl update brought to you by Flomax. Coming up next on ESPN, opening night of bowl week. It's the St. Petersburg Bowl, Rutgers and UCF. We'll find out which are the mightiest of the two teams named the Knights. Now, UCF's playing about 100 miles from their campus. George O'Leary's team, known for a stout defense. They'll try to stuff Rutgers' run, get after the passer, the freshman quarterback, Tom Savage. The Scarlet Knights, also at 8-4, have a big play offense, but the concern is the hamstring of Tim Brown. Can he go and for how long? If he can't contribute, Mohamed Sanu, the talented freshman, will have to step up. It's the St. Pete Bowl, Rutgers and UCF, coming up tonight.
They're running the men's room marathon.
With lots of guys going over and over.
And here's the dash to the men's room with lots of guys going urgently.
And then there's the night game.
Waking up to go.
These guys should be in a race to see their doctors.
Right. Those could be urinary symptoms due to BPH, an enlarged prostate.
But for many guys, prescription Flomax reduces their urinary symptoms due to BPH in 1 week.
Only your doctor can tell if you have BPH, not a more serious condition like prostate cancer.
When taking Flomax, avoid driving or hazardous tasks until you know how Flomax will affect you, as a sudden drop in blood pressure may occur, rarely resulting in fainting.
Tell your doctor about all medications you take. If considering cataract surgery, tell your eye surgeon you've taken Flomax.
Common side effects are runny nose, dizziness, and decrease in semen.
Ask your doctor if Flomax is right for you.
Call 877-4-FLOMAX to see if you qualify for up to $40 off new or refill prescriptions.
For many men, Flomax can make a difference in 1 week.
Where are you up? It's 2 a.m.
It's 2 a.m. Christmas morning. I couldn't wait.
Savings on select diamond earrings. One more reason K is the number one jewelry store in America.
Every kiss begins with K.
In the NBA, you're always looking for an edge.
need to know your opponent better than they know themselves. Kobe, Carmelo, LeBron. I get my edge with NBA League Pass from DirecTV. I see every game, so I'm always ready. Are you?
Watch any NBA game you want, no matter where you live. Call today.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
This is your day of reckoning.
Earth may be his next target.
I've been waiting for this my whole life.
Get one shot.
Now!
Either we're going down, or they are.
Fire everything!
Do it!
Movies playing on channels 125 through 199.
Leading rusher in the nation, yards per game, Ryan Matthews. So far, 7 carries, 51 yards, and a touchdown just a moment ago to tie things up at 7. So Andrew Shapiro will kick it away. Alvester Alexander back deep along with Marcel Gibson. Gibson, 2 yards deep. He's going to bring this back out and huddle. Who's got it? They run it the other way, and it didn't work. Out at the 10, and Fresno State was ready for it. And a little bit of everything. Alvester Alexander, and there's some extracurricular now on the sideline. There's also a flag. It came in late when they went out. And if you weren't with us early, we had this during warm-ups as well.
Yeah, a lot of barking going on, and there was a lot of barking going on in the skirmish before the game, but doesn't look like anybody's ready to throw down yet. This is an early start time, and both teams seem to be a little bit on edge.
So you didn't think anyone was going to get hurt in that skirmish before the game?
No. There was a lot of talking, but not much behind it. And
as there usually is.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. Yeah, we'll get the call.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. Number 32 on the receiving team. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
So they call it on Alvester Alexander, the man who eventually did have the football.
Well, this is old school right here. They do the little huddle and they give the ball to Alexander. And I think Alexander took exception to getting ridden over there into the billboard area. I can see why his feelings were hurt.
First and 10 from the 5. Brandon Stewart now in at tailback, so Alexander cools off on the sideline, at least for a play. Carter Samuels, the true freshman, going to bust through and take it all the way up close to a first down. He may have it. If he gets a good spot, they'll move the chains out at the 15. This is what we saw before the game.
I mean, the officials aren't having to work real hard to keep those teams separated right there. I don't think anybody's heart was in it.
Listen, if you're Fresno State, you come back with a little chip on your shoulder because of what happened last year, the loss to Colorado State here in the New Mexico Bowl. And if you're Wyoming, you're just waiting to get at it. You haven't been to a bowl since 2004. Not one player on this roster has been to a bowl game until today. Stewart had a couple of blockers ahead of him and picks up the first down out at the 18, a gain of 5.
Stewart's an interesting story. In a high school tailback, and he came to Wyoming actually as a wide receiver. And became the number one back, and now he shares time with Alvester Alexander, but very capable player, and he is a threat out of the backfield to catch the football.
This is a team, Wyoming, that was picked to finish last in the Mountain West. They ended up right in the middle of the pack, 5th. Curtis Samuels. Speed to the outside. Using it and picking up another first down. We had nowhere to run on this side of the football field. Eventually, a gain of 13. Chris Carter was there, but he ran by him.
Well, you talk about great feel and understanding of where defenders are in the pocket. Watch this. Carter's bearing down on him right here from behind. And Carter Samuels feels it, moves up into the pocket, And then he has the speed to get to the corner.
He's got 40 yards rushing already in this game, Curtis Samuels does. So it's first and 10 at the 32 now. Inside give. And Stewart's going nowhere, right at the line of scrimmage and put down there.
You know, we talked to Dave Christensen and all the weapons he had at Missouri. Chase Daniel, the wide receiving core, spread it out, throw it all over the field. And we talked to him earlier this week, Terry, and he said, we tried to do that the first few games here this season, and then we had to scale it back. We realized that we didn't have the personnel. We didn't have the athletes outside.
Yeah, brought it back in, a little less of a spread than they had, and more effective the second half of the season with it. Curtis Samuels throws it away. Yeah, it looked like a face mask, maybe they didn't call it. Chris Carter again with the pressure.
Well, and you talk about a spread offense, it's not just the wide receivers and the eligibles that are getting spread out when you're spreading on a defense. And when Christensen was at Missouri and running his true spread offense, the linemen, the offensive linemen take wider splits as well. And they're more athletic. And so you know, Christensen, when he had to scale back, they had to bring the splits in with the offensive linemen as well as the skill athletes.
Yeah, you don't think about that adjustment for the offensive line, but it was an adjustment early, and then they adjust back to what they were doing. Going to run it this way on third and 10. Got some room across the 40, and out across the 45-yard line goes Alexander. He'll pick up a first down. Gain of 17. Pokes fans who've made the trip here love it.
Yeah, when Fresno State has had problems, and it's been multiple games this season, when they have had problems stopping the run, it's generally been against option teams and teams that run the zone read. You know, running offenses where they have to take responsibilities, and again, Wyoming catches them with misdirection.
Stewart in at tailback on first and 10. Gets the call, gets the carry, spins into Fresno State territory just across midfield. Chase McEntee, the backup nose tackle with the stop. Ryan Matthews, Alexander, two big runs. Matthews, a touchdown. Alvester with a long run for a touchdown, 68 yards.
How's that for an average per carry? Pushing 25 yards. Of course, he cracked off the big touchdown run. But Wyoming, this is what they needed to do to have success. They had to run the football, and they're getting it done early.
A bowl game's a different animal. You have that much time to prepare. Stewart to the outside, hauled in from behind at the 47. Kyle Knox, a sophomore from L.A., ran him down.
It's interesting that you bring that up, Terry. The Wyoming coaching staff is talking about the time to prepare. That's not a horse collar. He's got him around the neck, but not from the jersey behind the helmet. The Wyoming coaching staff talked about, hey, we know we're the underdogs. This is a very talented team, not just on offense, but some athletes on defense for Fresno State. And they felt like they had the time to prepare and find some keys from film study. And you see it being put to use here in the first half.
Third and five, but before they get it off, Wyoming burns a timeout. So Dave Christensen wants to talk things over with 8 minutes and 12 seconds left until halftime. David Norrie's musical journey. Here's a hint what's coming next. Sandia Mountain High. It really doesn't help, does it? A little.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
What if a moment standing still could be just as beautiful? When it breathes, if some moments preferred to take their time, if photography moved us and we moved photography, and we could all see beyond the still. Moving photography in 1080p Full HD, pioneered with EOS, inspired by Canon.
Has the world gone mad? Jeans that cost $100, $75, $50. Jeans should fit comfortably and look good. New Lee Relaxed Fit are the best fitting, most comfortable jeans, guaranteed. Relaxed price, relaxed fit. Lee, get what fits.
Quentin Tarantino's Inglourious Basterds is nominated for 4 Golden Globes.
Sound good?
Yes, sir!
Best Supporting Actor, Best Screenplay, Best Director, and Best Picture.
How fun!
Inglourious Basterds. Only 2-disc special edition for a limited time only.
It's coming. The big night. Make sure the milk and cookies are standing by. And the Bass Pro Shops for great last-minute gift ideas. Like Redhead printed knit shirts for just $14.94. And Redhead chamois shirts for just $19.94. Plus, there's still time for a free picture with Santa. Time passes. Hold on to Christmas.
NewMexico.org.
It's Christmas time in New Mexico, and maybe the most special gift the state has ever given us was the late, great John Denver. He got his start in the mid-60s with the Mitchell Trio. His 70s solo career was nothing short of transcendent. A string of number one hits and albums, huge success as a TV personality, and live concerts broadcast across the world. His late career was focused mainly on humanitarian and environmental efforts. And while he died tragically in 1997 in a plane crash off the California coast, his legacy of humanity and music will live on.
John Denver, born in Roswell, New Mexico in 1943, 4 years before the aliens landed there.
Wasn't that a great shot there? I don't know if people picked that up. That was Sinatra and Count Basie with him on stage.
Ninth play of the drive. It's been a long one. Started back, you remember, deep inside their own territory. Brandon Stewart run out of bounds here. You think about John Denver and how big he was. The Tonight Show, right? He guest hosted
all
that
all the time for Johnny Carson. Hosted 5 or 6 Grammy Award shows.
Yeah.
Countless TV specials. He did a Christmas special in 1975 that went out across the world to 60 million viewers.
And as we saw a moment ago, he had Frank Sinatra as a backup singer at least one time.
And Count Basie on the other side on piano.
4th and 2 coming up, and Pat Hill went for it. Dave Christensen's going to go for this one. Carlos Samuels carries it close to that marker. We'll see where they spot it. Ben Jacobs was there to make the stop. That's a first down. They'll move the chains.
Yeah, and that was a nice play by Carter Samuels. He had to recognize the cutback in the lane. And he has been very effective. Doesn't have great speed. He's not going to make a lot of people miss, but he's very decisive with his cuts and a big play to move the chains.
This is an offense that's been pretty impressive on this drive. Driven down the field and now just outside the 40. Alexander caught from behind and dumped right at the 40. Logan Harrell, the sophomore who was a starter going in the fall camp, had to shift some things around because Kenny Borg, the normal starter, defensive end, was injured against Illinois in their last game. So Harrell getting a start. Chris Lewis moving outside to that defensive end spot.
Yeah, and with Borg, you know, Borg's a playmaker, and he complimented Carter well. That was a big loss, Borg going down in that game against Illinois.
Out of the gun, play action, going to throw over the middle, complete, and a first down to the 22-yard line. Good play action. Jessen Salyards, the tight end, the catch for a gain of 17. So you run it, you run it, you run it, and play action gets a big gain.
And this is just a nice play design. The play action fake holds the linebackers, sucks those linebackers up near the line of scrimmage, and the ball came out on time.
First down at the 23. Play action again. To the end zone they go and overthrown. Carter Samuels throws it to the back of the end zone. Might have been a good choice anyway. There was double coverage down there.
Yeah, that's not really Wyoming's game. They're not a vertical passing team, and they're averaging about 9 yards, 9-10 yards a completion. You look at Fresno State. They go for chunks off of play action.
Ryan Matthews running the football, and you know, Fresno State averages about 10 yards per attempt in their pass game.
That was a brilliant play on the previous one to pick up the first down, but they went back to it and wasn't there. So it's second and 10 from the 23. Stewart in motion. He gets the football looking for a block. Not going to get it. Dumped at the 22 by Ben Jacobs. Sun beginning to creep across the sky here. Mako Bowl Las Vegas coming your way Tuesday, 8 o'clock Eastern time. This one will be a good one, David. Oregon State that close to going to the Rose Bowl, taking on number 14, BYU.
Yeah, BYU team, one of the only teams this year to really wax Wyoming. TCU was another, but how about that matchup? And how about the job that Mike Riley did at Oregon State? Just one drive away from being in Pasadena on New Year's Day.
And he does not lose bowl games. 5-0. Reno as a coordinator. Curtis Samuels throws off balance. Jump ball in the end zone. Let's see who came down with it. Touchdown, Wyoming. You get the signal. Greg bowling high into the air to make a spectacular grab.
Well, Greg Bowling was suspended early in the season, and he's one of the biggest playmakers in this wide receiver corps for Wyoming. And remember, a simultaneous catch goes to the offense. So even if he didn't clearly have it over the defensive player there in terms of possession, if they both have the ball simultaneously, that's a touchdown.
There were three players with a chance to make that grab or interception, and it's Bowling who comes down with it, and the Cowboys up by a touchdown.
ESPN Monday Night Football, Giants Redskins at 8:30.
What can you do when you have a rich, unique blend of culture, cuisine, and climate all in one amazing place? You can do it all.
To plan your trip to Albuquerque, visit itsatrip.org.
Want something really fresh this holiday? Come on into Outback and try our juicy special sirloin and freshly grilled lobster tails, plus a freshly made side, all for just $14.95. And purchase $100 in gift cards and get a free $20 bonus card. Live adventurous. Go Outback.
The Gators have beaten the Alabama Crimson Tide and knocked them from the ranks of the undefeated.
I think Alabama, who everybody's forgetting about, is the team to beat in the SEC West.
Touchdown! It's blocked. The Crimson Tide wins. California, here we come.
The 2010 City BCS National Championship Game. Number 2 Texas versus number 1 Alabama. Coverage begins January 7th at 8 Eastern on ABC.
More cash over here.
It's much easier to find money at Esurance. Great auto insurance rates and lots of discounts.
Got insurance already? Save more with Esurance's switch and save discount.
It also pays to shop online. You get Esurance's Fast 5 discount just for getting an instant online quote.
Thanks, Professor.
Don't forget the good student discount.
And there's even more discounts.
It's no secret that you can save hundreds with Esurance.
Make it your mission to click or call Esurance today.
I'm Bob Vila. To me, a room is more than a place to live. It's an expression of who you are. And nothing makes a room stand out like Bellawood hardwood floors. Bellawood floors are 100% solid wood. They're pre-finished and come in over 120 choices.
I saw the Australian Cypress and I knew this is it.
Bellawood's finish is 3 times more durable than other brands, and it's backed by a 50-year warranty.
My installer said this is the best wood flooring he's ever used.
Call or click now for a free Bellawood catalog. Bellawood.
Now on sale at Lumber Liquidators.
ESPN College Football, the New Mexico Bowl, is brought to you by the Canon EOS Rebel T1i, shooting in 1080p full HD video, inspired by Canon, and Inglourious Basterds from Quentin Tarantino, now on Blu-ray high def and DVD.
Yeah, players taking in the week in Albuquerque. The pep rally yesterday. They had the Chili Bowl at El Pinto Restaurant. It's become a tradition here, where the players actually cook chili, and then they have judges who decide. Fresno State won that. I know you've been waiting to hear it, David, who won that. But here's the problem. In the three previous seasons, if you've won...
Here's the problem.
If you've won the Chili Bowl, you haven't won the game. And that's the way it's playing out right now. 14-7. Short little pooch out at the 22. And out to the 35-yard line they go.
I would venture to say if you win the Chili Bowl, you might lose the game.
For
I mean, whoever's
reason.
Doing best in the Chili Bowl, that could... All right, let's watch here. Bowling's going to come all the way across the field. Alexander on an up route, and they keep working their routes to the point that they're both in the same spot on the field. And that's really not something that you want to have in pass offense, but Bowling goes up with strong hands. You know, Bell is there in the back of the end zone. And then you had A.J. Jefferson also going up for the football. Just a great individual play by Bowling to go up and make that catch, even over his own teammate, Alexander.
So Fresno State, pretty good field position to start this drive. From the 35, going to run it out to the 37. Gain of maybe two for Ryan Matthews. Are you surprised at the way this one has progressed?
Well, I have been surprised at the way that Wyoming has been able to move the football. You know, they have not been very potent on offense. But remember, Fresno State has struggled. This has not been one of their better defensive units. What surprised me is Pat Hill's offense. You know, they have made some big mistakes. The fumble in the red zone, the 15-yard penalty that stopped their opening drive, and Fresno State has their hands full at this point.
Fresno State going back to the ground game at this point. They threw it off and early and now doubling up. About twice as many runs as passes. Matthews the carry again. And Mitch Unrein on the stop. But that's their calling card. It's what they do or what they'd like to do, establish that running game.
Well, and what he does so well and the big challenge for defense is he makes... It's so tough on the initial tackler. He either runs through tackles, he makes you miss. So you can have a play defense. You can have a defender in the right position to make the play, and Ryan Matthews makes you wrong.
Fresno State has not thrown a pass here in the second quarter. Third and three. We'll see if they throw it here. They're going to call a timeout first as that play clock was running down, so we'll step away as well. 3 minutes, 29 seconds until the halftime break.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
We started with over 1 billion colors. Generously added more than 2 million liquid crystal pixels. Combine 960 backlighting LEDs with 240 flawless scenes per second, made it 50% more energy efficient. And it all came down to one thing. The new 55-inch True LED from Vizio. Superior picture performance, superior price from America's number one LCD HD TV company.
Extreme power of Energizer Ultimate Lithium. The world's longest lasting AA battery in high-tech devices. Energizer, keep going.
Would you like to go for a ride in that bike?
Okay.
Okay. Whoa, yeah. You see, the terms require you keep the bike in this predetermined space. If you want to take the bike out, I'm going to have to charge you a penalty.
I can't really ride in this little space.
Well, you can't ride very far.
Even kids know an offer shouldn't come with ridiculous conditions. Why don't banks? We're Ally, a new bank whose no-penalty CD lets you withdraw all your money and bring it anywhere without a fee. It's just the right thing to do.
Hi, I'm 10.2 miles past Route 4 and I need some help.
The Help Me feature, only from TomTom.
go confidently.
I tried the other energy drinks, and what made me switch was the size of the drinks kept getting bigger and bigger. I just wanted energy. I didn't want to get bloated. The 2 ounces of 5-Hour Energy really does make a difference. With the other energy drinks, it was kind of a sugar high. I felt on edge, and that's not what I'm looking for before I go on a mountain bike ride or a run or a swim, and I never felt that with 5-Hour Energy. It gave me a boost, and the boost lasted, and I never crashed. It gives you that sense of alertness. Nothing works like 5-Hour Energy.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
Back at the 4th annual New Mexico Bowl. Happy holidays, everybody. We kick off bowl season, 14-7 Wyoming over Fresno State. Got a 3rd-and-3. The Bulldogs do coming up in just a moment. They burned a timeout, and now Wyoming has taken a timeout. And I mentioned it a moment ago, David, the fact that here in the second quarter, Pat Hill has yet to throw the football. They kind of used the pass now, or did, to set up what is their bread and butter, the running game now.
Well, early on, the first couple series, Fresno State came out. They knew Wyoming was gearing up for the run. They're putting numbers up on the line of scrimmage until Fresno State opened things up with the pass game to start the game. They shot themselves in the foot with some penalties, a big turnover in the red zone. And now all of a sudden, Fresno State here down 7 points are saying, we're going to get back to our bread and butter. We're going to start feeding it to Matthews.
Back to number 21. Here they go. Leaping, but stopped short of that first down marker. A number of tacklers in there. It may have been Gabe Napton, I believe it was, who got there first. Napton, the sophomore from Colorado and the heart and soul of this linebacker corps.
Yeah, well, Napton is one of the top tacklers, not only in his conference, but in the country. In fact, there are 3 players on this defense that are amongst the leaders in college football.
Yeah, 3 in the top 19 in the country. Going for it on 4th down again. They're going to pick it up with Matthews straight ahead. So it's the second time in the game that Pat Hill has gone for it on 4th down and picked it up both times. And, of course, you got a big number 79, Devin Cunningham, leading the way. And you feel pretty good about your chances.
That's an interesting dynamic. You get some decisions from coaches that you wouldn't get in a regular season game, even a non-conference game during the regular season. And coaches are more apt to go for it on 4th down. You know, in your own territory, Pat Hill, during the 12 initial regular season games, he's going to punt the football away.
Cunningham, the man who caught the tipped 2-point conversion pass and got to the end zone against Illinois. They run the reverse, got a block from Colburn, the quarterback. Looking for another block is Moore, and one out. They're going to mark it at the 43-yard line, and he should have another first down.
Went out of bounds by number 2, Marcel Gifford.
Well, if you've ever played quarterback, you know that on a reverse, you have a blocking assignment, and it's going to be right here, Fletcher. And this is a nice job by Colburn to square him up. And that's really all you needed for Marlon Moore to gain the corner.
Marlon Moore, maybe their fastest wide receiver. Slowed by injuries last year. Is it a solid year this year, though?
Yeah, they've got some experience. Ajira Tutu, Moore, Chaston West, all seniors. And then guys like Hamler. Hamler had such a big game down the stretch against Illinois. Touchdown catch to bring them within 1. And then you got Devin Wiley. He's a sub 4-3 guy, and he's just back healthy coming off the hamstring.
Now, Wiley may have been their best playmaker out there. He's had a hamstring injury and missed 4 games. And Pat Hill pointing up to the clock. An issue.
Wyoming's headsets have gone down. Fresno State will put theirs down as well. Please reset the game clock to 2:03.
So chivalry's not dead. It's a gracious gesture.
I don't think they had much of a choice. You think either they're doing it by choice?
Either do I.
So it's a communication breakdown. That's the issue, not a clock issue.
What is that up in the booth? Is that just a personal call? I mean,
you get out the old cell phone and make the call next.
Who's that guy talking to?
So Pat Hill and his staff will not communicate until they get both sides working. There's Marcus Arroyo up there, the offensive coordinator, on the phone. 1st and 10 from the 42. surprising first half here at the New Mexico Bull. Hamler, the catch, tripped up at the 35-yard line. Good gain, though. He's got three catches on the afternoon. Jamel Hamler, the sophomore from California. Little explosion with Hamler, too. He's got speed. Wiley's got speed. Experience with Moore in his year at 2-2. And it brings up second and two. Hamler in motion. Matthews dances, patient, but no room to run. He does pick up that first down, and they'll move the chains. John Fletcher in on the stop. And it's been one of those Fresno State drives now. We approach that minute mark. And Pat Hill's club trying to get something on the board before the break.
Yeah, they've moved the ball at will at times here in the first half, but as is the case on Saturdays and Sundays, it's often about how you finish off drive.
Eighth play of the drive. They still do have those two timeouts left. Colburn guns it inside the 15. And connects with Chasten West, his second catch, and a big one here. So it'll be first and 10 from the 14-yard line, a gain of 17. Seconds until the break. Colburn from the shotgun. Matthews with him in the backfield. Three receivers set. Time looking to the end zone, now flushed out. Colburn runs it up the middle. And met at the 10 and dropped there. 38 and counting. And they'll whistle it dead on the timeout.
A good spot to use your timeout. Fresno State with plenty of time to tie this football game before the half.
All right, so they are down to one timeout, and as they take it, we will send it back to Chris Fowler in the studio. Chris?
All right, Terry, thank you. 37 seconds till the Cars.com halftime report. Kirk and Desmond will join me. We'll look ahead to the bowl season, the teams that have the most to prove. We'll also preview tonight's matchup between UCF and Rutgers and highlights of the mega showdown on the hardwoods today, Texas and North Carolina. That's coming up in just 37 seconds. The Cars.com halftime report.
All right, Chris, thank you. I can't imagine playing a hoops game in Cowboys Stadium. That's massive.
Well, that used to bother, didn't that bother you? Your shooting when you play in those big cavernous, a carrier dome?
It's more those 6'5 guys that bothered me. The domes.
Or number 23 tracking you from behind, yeah. From North Carolina, right?
MJ. All right, second down and 6 coming up here after the timeout. So Fresno State with one timeout left.
This is where you won that title back in 83, right here in Albuquerque.
Checks in the mail. Thank
I didn't
for
forget it.
Yeah. Matthews stepping up. Colburn looking to the end zone over the middle. It's caught. Did he keep his feet in? Did he hold on? We'll wait for the signal. It is a touchdown. And it was Jamel Hamler with another big catch.
Now this is a beautiful ball and a pretty catch in the back of the end zone. The ball was placed right on the money. Nice feet by Colburn, and the timing on the throw was perfect.
So you get the emphatic statement about what happened, and it's 6 on the board. Well, Hamler has made some big plays for this team. Just a sophomore. Kevin Getzling on. Also a sophomore for the extra point. And they'll stop it before. It's 52 of 52 coming in terms of point afters.
The Wyoming head coach is challenging the ruling on the field of possession of the play.
All right, so as you know, they take a look at every play And then they take a closer look should there be any question. But now Dave Christensen wants an even closer look.
Well, and this is Hamler right here, and he's going to work to the back of the end zone, but he's going to have to get behind defenders. And that's where Colburn leads him to the window. And pretty footwork along the end line.
This might give you a better look at it and whether he held on.
Yeah, he had to extend the football. Had to extend the hands to make the catch on the football, rather. But I think he not only gets that first foot down, but I think he gets the second foot down.
And that
makes a difference, not from a possession standpoint. You only need 1 foot down in college football, but if there's any question on whether he had the ball securely, that second foot, I think, seals the deal.
And as you look at his hands there, he's not juggling it either. So yeah, he had it secured. And the ruling on the field should be upheld.
That was a nice play by Hamler to extend. That was not an easy play in the back of the end zone, and pretty impressive throw from Colburn to lead him.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Touchdown. Wyoming is charged with their final timeout.
But if you're Dave Christensen, you feel like, well, why not?
If you're gonna force a look at the play, you want to make sure it's a play that's worthwhile, and this obviously is a touchdown. So tough to defense that type of route when the throw is that good.
So Gessling on for the point after now. And right through the upright. So we are tied at 14 with 33 seconds left until halftime here in Albuquerque. A reminder, Monday night, don't miss an NFC East battle in the nation's capital, as long as they get that ready by then. Eli Manning, the Giants, taking on the Redskins, 8:30 Eastern time. Coverage kicking off with Monday Night Countdown, served by Applebee's at 7 o'clock Eastern. What, 2 feet of snow in the nation's capital today?
Well, we're headed west. We're not headed east.
But my travel plans are just fine.
Now make sure you don't miss that flight to Honolulu on Monday.
Yeah, how about Ryan Colburn right now? 9 of 10, 97 yards and a touchdown.
Well, he has had some big games this year. He threw for 4 touchdowns against Wisconsin. He's a perfect 14 for 14 against Idaho. And how does that feel when you're quarterback and you're in the locker room after the game and you didn't have an incompletion?
You remember a game like that?
No, I don't.
UCLA for you?
I don't. It would have to have been in another life.
So it's not that you just don't remember it. It may not have actually happened.
You'd have to believe in reincarnation for that one to come true.
All right, 33 seconds left until the break. James Carraway back deep. Along with Elbuster Alexander. Andrew Shapiro, who is the kicker, who also wears number 35, just like Kevin Gessling. He handles their extra points and field goals on. This one will go out, come out to the 40-yard line.
Well, we haven't seen either one of these place kickers in the first half, at least on a field goal try, but Gessling for Fresno State and Watts for Wyoming. How big did they play into these team seasons?
Very good.
We talked about perfection.
Kick out of bounds on the kicking team. 5-yard penalty from the 35-yard line. First down.
And they were close to perfection. Watts was 10 for 11 on the year for Wyoming, and Gessling 15 for 16.
Gessling first team all WAC performer.
And if Watts doesn't hit that kick late against Colorado State in the rivalry game, Wyoming isn't in a bowl game.
Watts had 3 game winners, as a matter of fact, on the year. First down at the 40. And they want to try to get some points on the board. Curtis Samuel's going to run it across the 50. Boy, just powered his way across midfield. Well, Deisha Dunn made the stop, David.
Well, in 25 seconds left here, as long as you throw the ball beyond the stakes, you can keep the clock stopped. And they want to see if they can get a 3-point effort off here. Nice job by Curtis Samuels. He continues to frustrate that front four for Fresno State.
Long field goal this year for Ian Watts, a 43-yarder, trying to get there, maybe closer. Lofted it up, caught, far sideline. Nope, out of bounds. Incomplete. Now Vester Alexander comes right down out of bounds.
That's a tailback, ladies and gentlemen. And again, they're using him on a circle route out of the backfield. And what an athletic play to go up and at least make the catch and try to get a foot down. And Carter Samuels, this coaching staff for Wyoming talked to us about his mobility and how he helps his big guys up front. He has been masterful in the first half.
Offensively, they've done some nice things on offense. Scheme-wise, maybe some new in here. Little lateral near sideline and a big gain. Out of bounds at the 33 goes Greg Bowling. So Leonard catches it initially, David.
And that was a great job to get the football free. He was tackled. The ball was hemmed against his body, and he fought to get it free and make the lateral, and Wyoming gets a shot here.
6 seconds left, so they're going to place it down right at the 40. It'll be a 50-yard try. Fresno State.
Timeout. Fresno State, their final.
Takes their seconds. Final timeout.
Yeah, that must have been a personnel issue for the Bulldogs, because you don't want Wyoming in this situation to be able to catch their breath and then set up a comfortable attempt on the field goal.
You're talking to the coaches, they feel comfortable with Ian Watts out to maybe 47, 48 yards right there.
Yeah, he said, you know, we need to get down into the 20, 25-yard area with the football. And of course, that'd be about a 42, 43-yarder. So this is outside his comfort zone. You know, when they hit that ball to Leonard there, I'm thinking, what are you doing? You're throwing the ball in front of the chains. You don't have a timeout. You're gonna bleed the clock to zeros. And all of a sudden, you see the hook and ladder.
They had a plan. All right. So this will be a 50-yard try for Ian Watts, who's been, what a story he's been, a walk-on unrecruited, and he's had a great year.
You got to make sure you don't get this blocked.
He does. They block it, trying to jump on it now and cover it up at midfield. That's a great call. That's the dangerous aspect, and they'll block one again. And that Fresno State under Pat Hill, well, they've made a living doing that through the years.
Yeah, it's going to be Ben Jacob, and you don't want to get it blocked, not because you don't get the 3 points. You don't want 6 points the other way. And, of course, the trajectory on the football is going to be lower with the longer try. Nice job by Wyoming to cover the football.
84th blocked kick or punt during the Pat Hill era at Fresno State.
Pretty amazing number.
And that will do it. It's been a good one here. 14 all at the break as we send it back to the studio and Chris Fowler for the Cars.com halftime report.
All right, Terry, David, thank you. Welcome. Desmond Howard, Kirk Herbstreit alongside here in Wyoming. One of the biggest underdogs of the entire bowl season have a one play and a 15 play touchdown drive, and they're hanging right in there. A field goal blocked there for the lead at halftime.
Told you, this Wyoming team is a gritty little team. Now, they have a lot of fight in them. They got the 6-6. No one expected them to even go to a bowl game, but I like their quarterback. He's keeping the chains moving. Austin Carter Samuels, this guy is playing well right now, and what he's doing is keeping the other team's offense on the sideline, which is key, keeping Ryan Matthews and those guys on the sideline.
But the big run by Alexander, I think, gave them a spark and got them to really believe that they had a chance to compete. The other thing is, for the most part, Wyoming, you'll see this in these bowl games all year, Wyoming looked a little bit more excited, looked like they had a little bit more to play for early in this game. The drive by Fresno State late, be interesting to see how these teams come out in the second half, because that was a big touchdown and a great throw again by Ryan Colburn.
And a great catch by Jamel Hamler, getting 2 feet down and grabbing that thing at the back of the end zone. So 14 apiece in Albuquerque, the second half coming up. In the meantime, at halftime, we'll peek ahead to bowl season. Rutgers and UCF collide tonight in St. Pete, and these guys will have their thoughts on other bowl games, plus hoops highlights ahead.
Lindsey Vaughn, report to Coldview Simulator.
Where do you go to bury limitations? To redefine preparation? To become the world's greatest downhill ski racer? The Under Armour Cold Gear Headquarters, only at Dick's Sporting Goods.
Why would any fun-loving, red-blooded, all-American male give up watching football to upgrade his headlights? Because Silver Star Ultra headlights from Sylvania are up to 50% brighter, and let you see up to 40% farther and up to 50% wider. But more importantly, because it's easier to replace a couple of headlights than it is...
Thanks, Dad.
A daughter. See farther, see wider, see better. Silver Star Ultra Headlights from Sylvania.
The most controllable, most advanced off-road racing game is here. It's called Reflex. What are you doing to get yours ready? Fast action calls for fast reaction. Ready to be for everyone.
Meet Diana. She said she wanted a PC that wakes up faster. So Windows and Toshiba said, we'll not only build it, we'll fly you to Tokyo to approve it. Diana, meet the Toshiba T135 satellite with Windows 7 and blazing fast wake up.
That's freaking fast.
Sounds approved to us.
I'm a PC, and fast the wake up was my idea.
If you ever make international calls, only Vonage gives you unlimited calling in the U.S. and around the world for just $24.99. Introducing Vonage World. Call 877-4-VONAGE today. Then call India, all of India, or Brazil, all of Brazil. In fact, call all corners of over 60 countries free. And now, sign up by December 31st and get 1 month free. Don't wait. Call 877-4-VONAGE or go to Vonage.com and start saving.
My top pick this season, Applebee's 2-for-20 game time lineup. One appetizer, two entrees, $20. Kicking things off, Dan Wingmaster Wilson and Joe Appetacker Davis score with boneless buffalo wings. Second half, 7-ounce house sirloin and 3-cheese chicken penne. Dan goes for the fake, denied. Let's break it down. One appetizer to share, two entrees. Final score, $20. This deal could go all the way. 2-for-20, only at Applebee's. Score!
This halftime report is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard.
Santa making an early appearance there. Taking time out of valuable Christmas shopping to watch this bowl game. We do appreciate that. Two games today. 19 days from now, we'll all be out in Pasadena, the BCS championship game. In the meantime, 34 bowl games wedged in. Besides Bama and Texas, you get three other teams trying to complete undefeated seasons in the bowl. You get the Bobby Bowden farewell. Yeah. So what game strikes you as the most intriguing of the whole bowl season?
See, if I think it's the Fiesta Bowl, TCU, I like this team. I like them. They're matched up this week. I mean, this game against Boise State. Two teams who are really trying to put their names on the map because they're undefeated and they're not in the big game, the national championship game. So they're still fighting for that type of respectability. I like TCU's defense, one of the tops in the nation. Jerry Hughes, defensive end. I want to see how he can compete against Boise State. Kellen Moore, fantastic quarterback. This guy's unbelievable, Kurt.
There's so many games to pick out. I tried to pick one off the board here. How about Wisconsin and Miami? Both teams at 9 wins. Both teams have a chance, obviously, if you can win, to get to 10 wins on the season. A lot of momentum into next year for both these teams if they have a chance to win this football game. So that one, of course, also a contrast in styles. You have the speed of Miami against the style of Wisconsin, very much more physical. So I'm looking forward to watching that one.
Yeah, the Canes defense, once they get healthy, the last four games played very well down the stretch. We'll see if they can stand up to the Badgers' muscular running game there. Most exciting player, a guy that you're going to look for in this bowl season, individual guy.
Yeah, CF, I think it's Ryan Williams, the running back for Virginia Tech. To me, he was the biggest surprise of the whole year. This kid didn't even know he was going to start coming into the season. But what did he do? He led the ACC in rushing with 1,538 yards. He scored 19 touchdowns and averaged 5.7 yards per carry. Going up against that Tennessee defense, though, they only yield 142 yards a game. So I want to see how he matches up against a tough SEC defense, Kirk.
Wow, that's a good one. I'm going to look for a running back, too. Toby Gerhardt, I think, obviously got some attention this year at Stanford, 8-4 year. Probably the most attention came after the Notre Dame game. Finished very close to winning the Heisman Trophy, but now he goes up against Oklahoma's defense. Bob Stoops, Brent Venables, the defensive coordinator Norman will have plenty of time to get their defense motivated and fired up to go on to take on Toby Gerhardt. But Toby Gerhardt, I think, is going to be motivated himself. Andrew Luck, the young freshman quarterback, will not be playing in this game. So Gerhardt may have to carry the load that much more. And you can imagine Gerald McCoy and Oklahoma's defense, they're going to be very, very tuned in to take a number seven out.
Yeah, Gerhardt the target, and Stanford a big underdog in that game without the quarterback playing. Yeah. And both these guys go against very good run defense, so we'll see how they stack up here. What about a team that's got something to prove in bowl season, Des?
I think Iowa. You know, the Hawkeyes, they started off having a Cinderella-type season with 9 straight victories, but then they ran into Northwestern, lost that game, and then they lost in Columbus against Ohio State. They ended their season by beating Minnesota, but look, they're getting Ricky Stanzi, their quarterback, back for this bowl game. I think they have something to prove to show that their season wasn't a fluke. So I like to see what the Hawkeyes do, Kirk.
We'll throw Iowa in there and the entire Big Ten Conference in there with something to prove. I'm going to say it's the Cincinnati Bearcats. Brian Kelly obviously off to Notre Dame to take the head job for the Fighting Irish, and I like the reaction from his players. They felt almost insulted that he would leave Cincinnati's program to go to Notre Dame, but play with the chip on the shoulder. If they can maintain that attitude that they had right after their banquet when Brian Kelly announced that he was going to Notre Dame, if they can hold on to that and stay focused, they can play much like West Virginia did when they lost Rich Rodriguez. Nobody gave them much of a chance at all to beat Oklahoma in the Fiesta Bowl, and they dominated them in that game. So, and Florida, do you think they're going to show up excited? You think
the offense will. Tebow will not let the offense be lackadaisical, but the defense, I wonder.
Without Charlie Strong, who's in Louisville now.
Yeah, we'll see.
That's going to be a good game.
You're right, the whole Big Ten's on notice here. Penn State, Western, Wisconsin.
It's been a good 3-year run.
Alvester Alexander had the big touchdown run, 14 apiece in Albuquerque at halftime.
Some say David Abernathy's extraordinary confidence began at birth, when he congratulated the doctor on a perfect delivery. He later approached the much older Carrie Pecor and simply said, "Call me." And she did. At 24, he performed open-heart surgery in a crowded opera house with a ballpoint pen. But when it comes to car buying, he's as nervous as anyone. So at 28, David Abernathy used Cars.com to regain his confidence to get the perfect car at the perfect price.
District 9, own it on Blu-ray December 22nd. The best way to watch movies at home ever. Blu-ray includes God of War 3 game demo and exclusive making of featurette.
I'm all shook up.
It's coming. The big night. Make sure the milk and cookies are standing by. And the chimney is open. Stop by Bass Pro Shops for great last minute gift ideas. Like men's and ladies' thermal Henleys for just $14.94. And the Redhead Elements jacket for only $29.99. Plus, there's still time for a free picture with Santa. Time passes. Hold on to Christmas.
Transform drinks you want into cold medicine you need. Introducing Fast Crystal Packs, a new way from Alka-Seltzer Plus to get cold and flu relief in a taste-free, fizz-free powder. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student-athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Bowl season continues tonight. A couple of 8-4 teams named the Knights will collide, Rutgers and UCF. It's the St. Petersburg Bowl. So the first ever bowl game in Russia, where it's quite frosty this kind of year. No, I'm told it's at St. Petersburg, Florida. So UCF will have the edge here, pretty good close one to their campus. Rob Stone checks in now with the preview.
The parking lots here at Tropicana Field filled up early in St. Petersburg, primarily because one of the teams in tonight's St. Petersburg Bowl, just about 106 miles away. Huge turnout here for UCF. Rutgers, their opposition, over 1,000 miles they had to travel to come to this game. And it's going to be pretty clear that Orlando's kind of shifted down to St. Pete for the day. Huge fan turnout for the black and gold. You see it behind me. Here's a quick visual for you. The Rutgers tailgate. Yeah, right up there on that balcony. You can count maybe 10 or 11 of them. Yeah, there's more Scarlet Knights here, but that's the way it's going to be. UCF sold through 4 ticket allotments for this game. They expect about 20,000 UCF fans. You look at the parking lots, could be even more. Now, for UCF, this is their third bowl game, still seeking their first bowl victory, and they think a win tonight would go a long way in upping their credibility, not only in Conference USA, but in the national picture as well. As for Rutgers, remember, not too long ago, this is a program didn't even know how to spell bowl. Now bowl games more of an expectation in Piscataway as Rutgers tonight seeks their 4th straight bowl victory. Coming up after the New Mexico Bowl, UCF taking on Rutgers.
Rob, thank you. Now weather that's more like St. Petersburg, Russia. This is in Virginia, the huge blizzard that's gone up and down the East Coast. It's the Stag Bowl, the D3 championship game, the 5th straight year. Mount Union with a 29-game winning streak against Wisconsin Whitewater, which takes the lead there. Little touchdown pass Jeff Donovan to Corey Robinson. Then Lavelle Coppage rushes over the left side, and 21-7. Mount Union in trouble, but they would rally. Wisconsin Whitewater is in the red zone. Donovan, a screen pass, and they build the lead back up to 14, 28-14 at that point. It's now a 7-point game. It's over on ESPN Classic. It was pushed back because of that blizzard. Ryan Matthews went to the locker room in the first set, came back out, dove in for a touchdown, 14 apiece in Albuquerque.
Of Armani this holiday at Macy's.
McDonald's Big Mac Avatar Thrill Card brings you more. Take your card to mcdonalds.com/avatar and prepare to be thrilled.
Hey!
Mr. Jones.
Would you mind if I paid you in gum?
That's New Trident Layers. Gum with layers of flavors. Of course you can pay me in gum.
I'd be crazy not to get paid in Trident Layers.
We weren't allowed to. Delicious strawberry with tasty citrus.
I love Trident Layers.
Yeah. No one ever pays me in gum.
Aww. Layers and layers and layers of flavor. Introducing new Trident Layers.
At the University of Wyoming, the future of energy is now. Every day, our students, faculty, and researchers are learning more about carbon-based energy, how it's produced, how it's used, and how to make it cleaner. We're investing in developing new technology, new knowledge that will usher Wyoming and the world into the next generation of energy. Our work in solar energy, wind energy, coal gasification, and oil recovery will lead the way to carbon management. Come see what the University of Wyoming is doing now.
You value your friends. So does DirecTV. Bob's worth 100. So are Carrie, Ann, and Sue. For every friend you refer to DirecTV, you get $100, and they get $100 on top of our new customer offer. Just give your account number to your friends and have them call 1-877-4100 each. They must have your account number when they order. This offer's only good for a limited time, so hurry. Then celebrate and watch the Benjamins stack up.
This December, celebrate with our best offer of the year.
Wow.
Get over $10 cash back from DirecTV Cinema when you order any 4 movies between now and the end of the year.
I love it.
Movies like The Hangover.
Through a night we'll never forget.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Julie and Julia.
I'm becoming a much better person because of her.
Bonjour.
Terminator Salvation.
We are all dead.
This month, order any 4 movies and get over $10 cash back. DirecTV Cinema, channels 125 through 199.
All I want for Christmas is you, baby.
It's the
gift that keeps giving all day. The NBA Christmas Special presented by Sprite. Action tips off at noon Eastern on ESPN, 2 p.m. on ABC.
Thank you, Mariah. Jerry Jones' football pals transformed into a basketball court today for the mega showdown between number 10 Texas and number 2 North Carolina.
It's your guy.
He'll play.
Let's get back to basketball. Texas perseveres here. They would take the lead late in the first half. Bradley would steal the inbounds pass. They let it 54-41 at the break. Bradley had 20 points. Carolina got back to within 6 in the second half. Marcus Guignard, the tough bucket. And it's a 4-point game. Guignard had 13, but Texas would pull away. James, big game. Layup and the foul. He had 25 points, 15 rebounds, and in the final minute, no punctuation here. Dexter Pittman, throwdown, and the heels beaten by the Horns. 103-90, Pittman finished with 23 points and 15 boards. One other basketball note, Kentucky now one win away from 2,000 all-time. They'll go for it Monday against Drexel over on ESPNU. They're 11-0 for the first time in about 16 years. All right, second half coming up from Albuquerque.
This halftime report is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard.
Some say David Abernathy's extraordinary confidence began at birth, when he congratulated the doctor on a perfect delivery. He later approached the much older Carrie Pecor and simply said, "Call me." And she did. At 24, he performed open-heart surgery in a crowded opera house with a ballpoint pen. But when it comes to car buying, he's as nervous as anyone. So at 28, David Abernathy used Cars.com to regain his confidence to get the perfect car at the perfect price.
What if a moment standing still could be just as beautiful? When it breathes, if some moments preferred to take their time. If photography moved us, and we moved photography, and we could all see beyond the still. Moving photography in 1080p Full HD. Pioneered with EOS, inspired by Canon.
What's a 13-letter phrase for marriage proposal?
I have absolutely no idea.
He went to Jared.
He went to Jared.
If you want to create your own one-of-a-kind ring, get to Jared this weekend. Because this weekend, you can receive Get Set in Diamonds rewards. Up to $1,000 toward a beautiful diamond setting when you buy your diamond at Jared. Choose from thousands of diamonds at hundreds of settings. Get up to $1,000 reward this weekend at Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
We were stuck in a basement apartment. Tiny rooms that the sun never blessed. So when we needed space for a family, set our sights on the wide open west. Well, I thought we'd see Sierra Vistas and breathe air through its new fallen snow. But my poor credit score was a stinker. Now we rent by the week in Reno.
Free credit score and report with enrollment and triple advantage.
Water is the foundation of our nation's food source. Our growth and our future depend on it. It is the basis of all life. Competing demands for water from farms, homes, and the environment require delicate balancing. At Fresno State, advanced research is being transformed into hands-on field applications. Technologies developed today will safely recycle, reclaim, and conserve water for tomorrow while maintaining our quality of life. Fresno State, leading the way in developing solutions that impact the world.
This is ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have just witnessed sports history being made.
I am the champion. Okay. I am the champion.
Did it just keep serious in
lights, cameras, action? I think it did.
What?
Play like the champion.
Yeah. We welcome you back to Albuquerque and the fourth annual New Mexico Bowl, kicking off Capital One Bowl Week. Good ball game so far, maybe better than expected, 14 all, as Fresno State takes on the Cowboys of Wyoming. Terry Gannon back with David Norrie. And who would have thought with the ground game of Fresno State that at least through the first half, it's Wyoming who has outgained the Bulldogs on the ground so far.
Well, 174 yards in the first half for Wyoming. And they've done a great job of controlling Ryan Matthews. Matthews, 65 yards in the first half. And, you know, I've been really impressed with Austin Carter Samuels, the quarterback. He's a true freshman, but he's a great decision maker. He hasn't been forcing balls down the field. He's had great feel when pass rushers have come free on him. He's been able to escape and hurt Fresno State with his feet. I just love the way this kid is playing in this bowl game.
Good late touchdown by Fresno State, though, to tie it up. And it is the Bulldogs getting the ball to open up the second half. So 14-14 as the sun begins to set here in Albuquerque. Bulldogs getting the football to open up the second half. Marlon Moore brings it back and fights his way out to the 29-yard line. So how about some of the highlights from that first half, David?
Well, the big play, Alexander cracking it. Safety's taking poor angles. And this kind of indicated that Wyoming was going to have some success on the ground. And Fresno State had some early success moving the football, but the fumble in the red zone and then the touchdown by Bowling going up and making a strong play in the end zone. Wyoming very lucky to not have that field goal attempt, which was blocked, go the other way for six.
See if they can get Ryan Matthews going here in the opening set of downs in the second half. First and 10 from the 29. Matthews bounces outside, gets to the edge, and is run out of bounds up at the 37 by Marcel Gibson, the junior from Dallas and the older brother of the other cornerback for the Cowboys, to Sean Gibson. Renard Camp, the fullback, is the man who is down and injured.
Yeah, and he was in an offset position and looked like he got cut. And if you're going to play tailback at the next level, you've got to be able to bounce the football outside. Matthews does an exceptional job of doing that. But Renard Camp is an... he is a force in this offense. When they line up in the eye and you come downhill with him as a blocking back, it looked like the defender went low on it. Taking another look there. That was Weston Johnson getting into his legs. Yeah, sometimes defenders, if they're going to give themselves up on a play, they want to take the blocker out of the picture, so they'll go lower than the blocker. And on that play, I don't think Camp was ready for Johnson to get into him below his waist. That's a dangerous play.
It's hard to go lower than Camp. I mean, he's got a low center of gravity. Looks to be okay right now, so that's the good news. But Renard, 5'11", 270. How about that coming at you out of the backfield?
How would you like to be Mr. Johnson and see number 48 bearing down on you?
Gain of 8 for Matthew. So it's second and 2. They're going to throw to the near side as you're a 2-2 with the catch. Out of bounds, and that's a first down. First catch of the afternoon for Seyi Ajiratutu, the senior from El Dorado Hills, California.
Yeah, and the Bulldogs throwing first down, it's almost like stealing. Because Wyoming is overplaying the run. And they're getting extra jerseys up along the line of scrimmage. The defense really overplaying the run on first and second down, and there's a lot of room outside to hit balls for the quarterback.
Out of the eye on first and 10. Straight drop, Colburn to throw. Near sideline again, incomplete. Again, it was Ajiratutu he was trying to hit. So it brings up second and 10. Fresno State started the year 1-3. And they've won 7 of their last 8. But you look at those 3 games. I mean, Wisconsin, Boise State back-to-back, and then Cincinnati.
Yeah, and they were in all those games. I mean, Wisconsin double overtime loss. They held the ball for over 43 minutes against Cincinnati. And all 3 of those teams are ranked right now, a couple very highly ranked. Fresno State outgained all 3 teams.
Cowboys showing blitz. Now they back off a bit. lay it straight up. Quick throw, complete, got a first down at the 43-yard line. Devin Wiley, the junior from Roseville, California. Now, Wiley's a guy they've really missed. We talked about it. He had a hamstring injury, missed four games. Now he's back.
Yeah, the timing on this play is critical. A nice first choice read by Colburn. Puts the ball in the front pocket. And Wiley's a sub 4-3 guy, they tell me. It's pretty quick.
Fresno State moving the football on this opening drive of the second half. So far, whatever adjustments they made during the break, they've been working. Play action. Colbert hit as he throws. Incomplete. Jamel Hamler had a chance to make the catch. Would have been a great one, though. Mitch Unrein providing the pressure on Ryan Colbert.
And Unrein is going to unload on Colbert. We've talked about it over the years, Terry. You play quarterback, you got to play the position with courage. And Colburn sits in, takes a big hit. And the pressure there forced him to just overshoot his receiver on the sideline.
As a quarterback, you take a hit like that on a pass like that. Is it in the back of your mind the next time you drop back?
It shouldn't be.
But it might be. They run the reverse. West going to throw it. Got a man wide open. That's two of them, as a matter of fact. Touchdown. Jamel Hamler, there was nobody back deep for Wyoming. Penalty marker at the end of the play. 43 yards to the end zone. David, there was no one near Jamel Hamler.
After the touchdown, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 17. Result of the play is a touchdown. The penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
There's going to be a handoff here. The reverse is going to come around this way, and watch two receivers come free for Fresno State down the football field. Now, you talk about a defense biting on a specialty play. And look at the two receivers down the field. Unbelievable.
Within 30 yards of him, nobody was there. Kevin Gessling up and good. Barely, but good for the extra point. So Jamel Hamler with another touchdown catch. And then a stern conversation on the sideline after the penalty at the end of the play. But the Bulldogs impressive on their opening drive.
Now let's look at right here. I mean, two Bulldogs sitting and waiting. That's like on a fast break, Terry, where are you going to dunk it or are you going to give it to your teammate? I mean, who's going to take the reception? Either receiver could have taken the reception on that.
You can tell Hamler's not a point guard. He kept it. They had numbers, as they say. We'll sort this out in the flag on the extra point.
After the play, personal foul. Number 78, offense. Penalty will be enforced half the distance from the kickoff.
As they had the penalty on Hamler, and now 78.
Yeah, they got to let that go.
First one they don't let go, though. Hamler in the end zone after the 6 points. 21-14, Fresno State.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
Itchy dry scalp? Could be your shampoo. Now there's a new Selsun Blue just for itchy dry scalp. Strong itch fighters target the source of scalp itch, while 5 moisturizers keep hair healthy.
No more itch.
New Selsun Blue Itchy Dry Scalp.
Got a clue? Get the blue.
I love WeFit Plus. It has customizable workouts, 6 new exercises, 12 new balance games. Rhythm Kung Fu is my absolute favorite.
favorite game.
You do a right punch, lift your leg up, do a big group high.
Yeah.
On bird's eye bullseye, you're like flapping your arms. You have to try the obstacle course. You can run really fast.
Oh, wait, balance.
When you're done with one of the games, you have worked out. If you already own Wii Fit, upgrade to Wii Fit Plus for only $20. It is so much fun to not only play, but watch. Graded E for everyone.
Yeah, Junior Candy Sunday going there?
Yeah, man, it's only a dollar off the Everyday Value menu.
A dollar, huh?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
If I had a buck, I would join you.
Well, you don't.
In that.
You don't.
But I'm willing to wager for it. I bet you I know how many fingers I'm going to hold up.
That you're going to hold up?
Yeah.
I don't take that bet.
Two.
That's four.
Ah.
I should have taken that bet.
The Everyday Value menu at Sonic, where great value is served up all day, every day. Try a Junior Candy Sunday or a Junior Deluxe Burger. Sonic's Everyday Value menu. All this starting at just a dollar each.
NewMexico.org.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Jamel Hamler, the touchdown. Pretty nice play drawn up by Pat Hill, as a matter of fact. Jeff Grady, the offensive coordinator, and it's 21-14 Fresno State. And look where they're going to kick off from the two penalties, and they're kicking off from the 8-yard line.
Not a good spot for an onside here.
You think? Andrew Shapiro going to try to kick it as deep as he can. And at the 20-yard line, Gibson slips, spins, and up to the 37-yard line. How about that play for the touchdown, David?
Well, the Wyoming defense is really going to bite. They're going to set it up like Hamler's going to get a wide receiver screen. Here's a Jiratutu. He's going to just run right by, and then Hamler's going to trail. Watch Przinski, the free safety. You don't want your center field coming up and biting this hard. He comes all the way across the line of scrimmage. I mean, watch him from a center field position. I mean, that is not his responsibility, and not one but two wide receivers get behind the Wyoming secondary.
I mean, there wasn't anybody not fooled by that play on the Wyoming side. First and 10 at the 38. Austin Carter Samuels out of the pocket on the run, throws back this way, midfield. First down, what a throw on the run. Chris McNeil, the true freshman from Simi Valley, California, on the catch.
Carter Samuels makes decisions unlike a true freshman should. I mean, he never forces balls. He's safe with the football. He always seems to know when things are caving in the pocket. He keeps things clean. He helps his offensive line with his feet. That was a nice throw on the move.
Gain of 14, so it's first and 10 from the 48 of Fresno State. Keep it on the ground. Alexander brings it to the 35 and loses it late. He was down prior to that, a gain of 13. So Alvester Alexander, who had a 68-yard touchdown run early in this one, picks up another first down.
Now, this offensive line has done a tremendous job. Russ Arnold is the leader up front, the center. They got a couple good players outside in Otterson and Curvin, the tackles. And he was down there. Alexander continuing to have success.
Four receivers to the far side. Bring them back in. Brandon Stewart. He carries it down to the 31-yard line. Pretty good scheme, I think, throughout the afternoon for Dave Christensen with the time to prepare against Fresno State's defense.
Well, the spread run game, it takes a lot of the starch out of your aggressiveness. You take a defensive front who's, you know, the Fresno State defensive front is undersized to begin with, and then you take away their aggressiveness and you make them worry about responsibilities. Who's taking the pitch, man? How are you going to play the zone read?
Christensen, who was the offensive coordinator at Missouri, played in the Pac-10 for Washington back in the early 80s. Carter Samuels falls ahead maybe one. That's about it. Ben Jacobs, the stop.
And we really haven't seen a lot of pitch. I mean, we haven't seen much option. It's really been a zone read attack that's hurt Fresno State. It was the zone read play that Alexander sprung for the long touchdown in the first half, but this has been the soft underbelly for Fresno State. Their entire football team is run defense, and Wyoming right now is exploiting this front seven.
Pretty good on third down so far. 4 of 7, and have another one coming up, 3rd and 6. Under pressure, the throw complete. First down again inside the 25 to David Leonard. 70 catches on the year coming in. He's got 2 this afternoon.
Yeah, good quarterbacks feel space in the pocket, and they subtly move to those spots, but they keep their eyes down the football field. And they also throw the ball with accuracy, shading the ball away from defenders and danger down the field. Samuels really doing a nice job this afternoon.
Freshman of the year in the Mountain West this year, Austin Curtis Samuels. Stewart spins, wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage though. Number of guys there defensively for Fresno State. Chris Carter, the first one in. Sean Plummer also in on the hit.
Carter and Plummer, two of the most athletic defenders up front for Fresno State. Can't help but look back at that Nevada game, 461 yards on the ground for Nevada. Multiple teams have gassed this Fresno State defensive front on the ground.
Nevada's pretty darn good on the ground. Nowhere to run. Alexander thrown to the ground. Chris Lewis, that defensive end from Fresno, and a loss of 6.
Now Chris Lewis is a guy who would normally be playing inside. Kenny Borg went down in the season finale. Lewis moves outside, and that is a pretty good play on the edge. Staying after it. Got a couple handfuls of jersey. Fresno State is going to have to button things down here in the second half. Too many yards. 175 yards on the ground in the first half of Wyoming.
Got to imagine they'll go to the air this time, though. 3rd and 17. Alexander, the tailback. Time to throw. Alexander back to the original line of scrimmage and just past that inside the 25. So they'll place that down with 4th down coming up at the 24.
That's a smart play call and a good decision to come underneath. You want to set up a field goal try there. You don't want to get greedy and try to pick up the 1st down on 3rd and 19. And Alexander, a nice spin move to get his field goal kicker a yard or two closer.
So it'll be a 40-yard try. Ian Watts. Number is long this year from 43. Had one blocked earlier in the game. This one's good, though. So Watts through the uprights.
Yeah, he needed that yard or two.
He got it. 21-17.
What can you do when you have a rich, unique blend of culture, cuisine, and climate all in one amazing place? You can do it all.
To plan your trip to Albuquerque, visit itsatrip.org.
O is for objectivity, one of the basic principles of TD Ameritrade. It means you help investors, you don't just sell them. It means no hidden agenda.
TD Ameritrade always has, always will, put the investor, you, first. That's how they work. That's how they deliver objective investing help. That's what TD Ameritrade stands for. What does your investment firm stand for?
It's time for fresh thinking. It's time for TD Ameritrade.
In the NBA, you're always looking for an edge. You need to know your opponent better than they know themselves. Kobe, Carmelo, LeBron. I get my edge with NBA League Pass from DirecTV. I see every game, so I'm always ready. Are you?
Watch any NBA game you want, no matter where you live. Call today.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
This is your day of reckoning.
Earth may be his next target.
I've been waiting for this my whole life.
get one shot.
Now.
Either we're going down, or they are.
Fire everything!
Do it!
Movies playing on channels 125 through 199.
ESPN College Football, the New Mexico Bowl, is brought to you by TD Ameritrade and Vonage. Call 877-4VONAGE now for unlimited calls around the world. Vonage sounds good.
A spectacular view here. High above Albuquerque, the tram 2.7-mile ascent up to over 10,000 feet, Mr. Nori.
Yeah, I'd like to get over to Taos for a little skiing. I hear that is a nice ski area and high degree of difficulty, they tell me, most of the runs in Taos in Mexico.
Just wait till we go to Hawaii, do a little different kind. Maybe go surfing North Shore.
Go skiing over on the Big Island.
True enough. Marlon Moore bringing it back across the field and out to the 27-yard line. So 8:11 left here in the third, and Fresno State back to work. Impressive on their opening drive, but Wyoming not matching it. They got the field goal, but they've stayed right with them throughout almost three quarters now.
Well, the Cowboys had to run the football to have a chance of winning this game. Dave Christensen knew it, and I think they have done a nice job of keeping Fresno State off balance with the zone read. They've been spreading them out some, getting some of those Fresno State defenders out of the box. But, you know, this Fresno State offense just keeps coming at you, and eventually you have to outscore them or Fresno State has to make mistakes.
First down from the 26. Reynard Camp, the fullback who went out on the last series, is back in, so he's okay. Leading the way in the eye with Ryan Matthews, and they'll throw the flag.
Well, that's a delay of game. Colburn lost sight of the play clock. And Pat Hill's not very excited about a veteran quarterback losing sight of the clock.
Timeout, Fresno State. They're so first.
They got the timeout, I guess, before the penalty.
You know, I think one of the officiating crew allowed it from the call from the sideline, and Dave Christensen is questioning it. He doesn't think that they got the timeout call from the sideline.
And you know
quick
what?
Enough.
Pat Hill doesn't know it either. He's out to talk to the officials to make sure. He's still upset. It went your way, Pat.
He is one of the great characters in college football. I'll tell you what, he has done such a great job winning games against BCS teams. You know, he has never, he's the longest tenured coach west of the Mississippi. He has never fired an assistant coach.
I mean, that's pretty amazing.
Right? You talk about loyalty, and not a lot of people know that about Pat Hill and the success that he's had against the big boys.
15 wins against BCS conference schools since 2000, most in the nation. I want to pick your brain about that, though, and the scheduling for Fresno State throughout the year and whether maybe it hurts them a little bit in conference play. Matthews the call. Straight ahead, still up. Still up. Far sideline. Almost to midfield. Good example of what Ryan Matthews gives you. Shamil Gary knocked him out.
Well, a lot of teams, I mean, and we see on Sundays, they'll pass to get ahead, and then they'll run to win the game in the second half. And Fresno State, this team is designed to wear you down in the second half. That is part of the blueprint for Pat Hill. And I can't think of a better back than Ryan Matthews to soften a defense as the clock winds down in the second half of the ball game.
From the 48, Matthews again tripped up right at midfield. How about, you know, this year they play Wisconsin, they play Cincinnati. Every year Pat Hill wants to go that anywhere, anytime, against anybody. But they've also, the last several years, had at least two losses in conference play in the WAC. You think it takes too much out of them then when they go back and play conference games?
Well, when he does receive criticism and flack, especially from some of the backers, and we know how things can be in college football with all the blogs and, you know, all the criticism out there, but usually it's losing a game or two against a conference opponent that they should win against. And the other thing, they have not had a lot of success against Boise State.
Matthews head for one, that's it. As a college football fan, though, you've got to love that. That attitude.
Yeah, and it isn't always just Fresno State. I mean, you got to give them credit for wanting, going out and seeking the big teams and playing, you know, the tougher opponents. But sometimes teams end up canceling on Fresno State, and Pat Hill has to scramble to find an opponent to fill those holes. And every now and then it's a USC, and that has been the case here, you know, during his tenure. So sometimes it's by design, sometimes it's not. But Fresno State, they step up in non-conference as well as any team in the country.
Third and seven out of the shotgun, Colburn. Matthews stays in. This one overthrown. The intended receiver, Chasten West, the man who threw that touchdown pass on the reverse to Sean Gibson on the coverage.
Well, Wyoming came in to this game close to a two-touchdown underdog. And anytime you can get Fresno State off the field, you can get and alone into the game here to punt the ball away for Fresno State. It's a huge win for not only your defense, but your team. And Wyoming, I think they're in pretty good position. I think Dave Christensen, if you would have given him 21-17, at this point, he would have taken it before the game.
Alone on for a punt. David Leonard back at his own 10. And this one a little too good. Into the end zone. They'll bring it out to the 20. Yard line when we come back. 6:06 left in the third here in the New Mexico Bowl.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 2nd.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
To pursue the life you want, you need a financial advocate who knows where you want to go. A Merrill Lynch financial advisor, now with access to the resources of Bank of America, can help you diversify, rebalance, imagine, and believe. Merrill Lynch Wealth Management.
For a limited time, you can carry out a large Domino's pizza with extra cheese and one topping for just $5.99. But there is one stipulation. Limit 256 per day. That is not happening.
For a limited time, carry out a large one-topping pizza with extra cheese for just $5.99.
Get ready to extend the pain.
Feel the pain!
With the Hangover Unrated version, it's completely outrageous.
Oh, funny.
Includes 100 new photos from the missing camera.
Oh!
The Hangover Unrated. Buy it on Blu-ray and DVD.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
Make that crazy. You guys are here too? What a coincidence, the way that sometimes works out. I'm just gonna stand if you don't mind. Yo, Mello, remember how you had 27 points per game in the whole playoffs? That was sick. And all I mean sick, like a dead animal on the road. We should stop the car and touch it with our hands. Sick. I mean sick, like awesome. You know? Hey, check it out. I got my own RV this year. Now I can follow you guys wherever you go. Great news, right? Best friends on one. Best friends.
ESPN, your NBA destination for games Wednesdays and Fridays.
21-17, Fresno State with the lead over Wyoming as we check out our K Jewelers storylines. Alvester Alexander, 68-yard touchdown run, longest run of the season for Wyoming. Hamler, a couple of touchdown catches, and Matthews sitting right on 99 yards.
Hamler picking up where he left off against Illinois.
And a big, really spectacular touchdown catch on that final drive to give them a chance to win. First down from the 20. Keeping on the ground. Out, gain of two for Brandon Stewart. Stewart getting plenty of action this afternoon. Almost 500 yards on the ground throughout the season. The second leading rusher right behind Alvester Alexander. Got 24 on the afternoon. So it's second and nine. Long count for Curtis Samuels. Looking to run it, can't. Dropped behind the line of scrimmage back at the 14-yard line. Kyle Knox, a sophomore from L.A., and a loss of six.
Yeah, Knox really times this well, and he just, and we're going to have it from the top left as well, and that was Knox coming up. Well, he was the alley guy. They got good pressure from the defensive end, and then Knox came up, fought off the tackle, fought off the block, and made a great tackle in the backfield.
That's where you get a lot from Carter being as effective as he is, and all the attention he draws at the defensive end spot. Throw on the run, incomplete. Carter Samuels looking to do the same thing he did successfully on the last drive, but Zach Bulger, the intended, and it brings up fourth down.
Yeah, and you're starting to get the feel of Wyoming with their lack of playmakers, a lack of speed. There's really no receiver on this team that can puncture a defense, get over the top, you know, on a post ball or a go route. And the defense is starting to lean on Wyoming. And Fresno State getting some nice work from Chris Carter, especially off that left defensive end position.
Marlon Moore back at his own 40. Austin McCoy barely gets that one off. Hit hard as he makes the play on the ball. Chaston West, one of the up men, a punt of 36 yards, and West paid for it. But he hung on. You got to be kidding me with doing that in college football or the NFL, returning punts. I mean, that is one job I do not want.
It is the toughest job on the football field. When you talk about, you know, you're sitting there, you've got your eyes trained on the football, and then you got athletes coming down the field running 4.4s, and they're looking to take a piece of you.
Chris Krasinski hits about as hard as anyone on that defense, too. First down from the 47. Matthews, as they keep it on the ground, and for good reason, bringing it all the way to the 46 of Wyoming. Just kicking things off here. Bowl season underway. R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl coming your way tomorrow, 8:30 Eastern time. Golden Eagles taking on the Blue Raiders as Southern Miss meets Middle Tennessee. Just starting to get things underway. 34 bowls in all. We got 27 of those on the ESPN family of networks.
34?
34, baby.
Wow.
January 7th, City National Championship game at the Rose Bowl. Matthews going nowhere this time. Josh Bazunes from Prior Lake, Minnesota. They'll move him around, David. He comes up, plays that buck position. He'll come up, play on the line in a four-man front, go back, be a linebacker.
Yeah, this is a 3-4 lineman. Bazunes plays an outside position, and you know, they are doing their best to put the game on Ryan Colburn's shoulders. They want to make the quarterback throw the football to win this game. And they got Fresno State in another third down situation.
And he's dropped behind the line. Mitch Unrein getting to Ryan Colburn, and that play never looked good. They never seem to get it going.
Well, and a nice job of staying disciplined on the pass rush. This is going to be Unrein. And the Wyoming defense has done a good job. Eight-man drop, three-man rush. And look at the work by the Gibson brothers on the line of scrimmage. There's Marcel Gibson.
Rugby-style punt this time from Malone. Leonard's going to think about it and then get away from him. They say it was touched prior to this point, but that's where they'll place it down. Now they will bring it out across the 10, out at the 13-yard line. Don't forget Monday Night Football coming your way, starting with Monday Night Countdown, served by Applebee's. Nation's capital, Redskins hosting the Giants. Washington coaching rumors there this week. Shanahan, perhaps.
Yeah, that guy will be watching. A lot of Shanahan talk.
You like that move?
And I think if you ever have a chance to pick up a Shanahan and you're going to have a vacant position, that's an assumption. I think he's the best coach that's out there.
Complete over the middle, across the 20 now, out to the 27 they go. David Leonard, the receiver. And all right, so Wyoming now, and the fans from Laramie who are here looking for a little work offensively. They've stalled here in the second half a bit.
Well, and again, You've got to do some things to get that defense from leaning and coming up on the line of scrimmage. Two very good safeties for Fresno State, and they are creeping closer and closer to the football.
First and 10 from the 27. Curtis Samuels, didn't read it well that time. Dropped at the 25 and a loss of two.
And we talked to Randy Stewart, the defensive coordinator for Fresno State. He said, yeah, you know, we've had trouble defending the run. When there have been big yards against us, it's usually on the big plays. But we're undersized up front. You know, and we've got a couple guys in Moses Harris and Lauren Bell that are great tacklers. So we have to play our strong card. We have to get them, you know, up into the run game. And I think they're doing a lot better job of that here in the second half.
And against an offense, too, that normally doesn't put up those big plays. Consistently, at least. Looking for one here. Football's loose, but he falls right on it. Fortunate to get that one back. Travis Burkhalter, a junior, dropped it and fell right on it.
Yeah, and this is going to be Burkhalter coming across the field on another. This is a jailbreak screen, the smash screen inside, and I think that's Lauren Bell, the safety, who made a nice play to strip the football. And sometimes recoveries are the difference in a football game. Very fortunate Wyoming to get that football back. Burkhalter covering the ball.
Cowboys have been very good taking care of the football this year. A big edge in terms of turnover margin when you compare them with Fresno State.
Quarterback draw maybe here.
To the outside he goes. The dive at the 38. He's close. Looked like he may have gotten there. Ben Jacobs running him down there. And it will be a first down.
Yeah, and I don't think that was a design play. You know, they emptied out, no running backs in the backfield. And, yeah, he picked that up. And Carter Samuels, you know, he's not a sub-4.5 guy. He's got some deceptive speed to him, but he just has a great feel. And when you're that decisive pulling the football down, it makes up for, you know, a lack of blazing speed.
Last glimpse of the sun setting here behind the mountains on the final couple of plays of the third quarter. Curtis Samuels running right into the white jerseys that time. Chris Lewis, the first man to get there, a loss of three. For a team that does not pressure all that much, they've had their share this afternoon against this Wyoming offense.
And Lewis is starting to play pretty effectively on the edge. He's gotten penetration. He's disrupted things in the backfield. Fresno State starting to rev it up on D.
We head to the fourth here in the fourth annual New Mexico Bowl.
From every major sport and league. Go to ESPNShop.com today.
76 asked student filmmakers to give their spin on what makes our gasoline so great. Here's one of the outstanding commercials.
Does your vehicle keep bogging down? Maybe it's time to get on the ball with 76 gasoline. It's specially formulated to clean your engine, improve acceleration, help maximize mileage, and above all, reduce emissions, making 76 one of the cleanest fuels available. Now and for generations to come. 76, get the spirit.
It's right here. It's easy. It's the money you could be saving with GEICO.
Who's watching?
It's right here. It's easy. It's the money you could be saving with GEICO.
At Dick's Sporting Goods, we'll help you find the perfect gift.
Earn scorecard rewards when shopping for everyone on your list.
I helped a mom looking for her athletes and a friend's running partner.
This woman who was really into fitness.
I helped a grandma with her list
and a dad shopping for his thrill-seeking sons.
I helped a golfer lower his friend's score and a wife hunting for gifts.
We can help you find any gift,
even gifts you haven't thought of.
That's right, Winston. We've got you covered.
Free shipping at dickssportinggoods.com on orders over $49. Every holiday season starts at Dick's.
Monday, back to spending time with people like this lady with the laugh and this guy with the breath.
It was huge.
But Monday means Monday Night Football on ESPN. And you're the only guy who matters on Monday night.
ESPN.
serving football fans everywhere.
Have an intense hunger for food and football? Satisfy your craving with our Game Time lineup. Applebee's and ESPN. It's always game time at Applebee's.
You value your friends. So does DirecTV. Bob's worth 100. So are Carrie, Ann, and Sue. For every friend you refer to DirecTV, you get $100, and they get $100 on top of our new customer offer. Just give your account number to your friends and have them call 1-877-4-100-EACH. They must have your account number when they order. This offer's only good for a limited time, so hurry. Then celebrate and watch the Benjamins stack up.
This December, celebrate with our best offer of the year.
Wow.
Get over $10 cash back from DirecTV Cinema when you order any four movies between now and the end of the year.
I love it.
Movies like The Hangover.
Through a night we'll never forget.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Julie and Julia.
I'm becoming a much better person because of her.
Bonjour.
Terminator Salvation.
We are all dead.
This month, order any four movies and get over $10 cash back. DirecTV Cinema, channels 125 through 199.
Old Town section of Albuquerque and still intact, cooking up some chilies. How about that, Mr. Norrie?
Muy spicy.
I had no idea you were so talented. I'll have to remember that one. 21-17 as we head to the fourth quarter, and Wyoming, you know, not many expected them to be as competitive, or some didn't, put it that way, in this game, and they're hanging around. Second and 13, incomplete. Little miscommunication, perhaps. Alexander out there as the intended. But how about you? How have they stayed in this one?
Well, you know, they had some success in the first half running the football, and now Fresno State has buckled things down, and they're forcing Carter Samuels to take some risks down the field, throwing the football, to move the football. They had success in the first half because Fresno State committed some errors, some penalties, and turnovers, but you know, eventually they're going to have to put the ball in the air if they're going to win this football game.
You took Spanish at UCLA, didn't you?
Muy caliente, I guess, would have been appropriate.
30-13 over the middle. Tipped up, intercepted. Fresno State has it. Bringing it back. Inside the five, stepped out of bounds at about the five-yard line. Chris Lewis, number 93, after it was tipped by Cornell Banks. And what a big play to open up the fourth quarter.
And this is what Fresno State does to you. They get you down fourth quarter. They force you to put the ball in the air. And that was a heck of a play by Banks to read Carter Samuels, read his eyes. And then how about the athleticism by Lewis? Carrying the ball a little bit loose down the sidelines there. It looked like he stepped out right about the 5 or the 6 yard line.
And they'll place it down at the 6. So it'll be first and goal from the 6 yard line.
The way he was holding that football, I'm surprised he didn't try to cut that thing back against the grain.
Little spin move. First and goal. Matthews, no surprise there. Legs moving, but just past the line of scrimmage. Hit hard by John Fletcher, and he wrapped him up.
Yeah, this is a big moment in the football game. Wyoming is just not the type of offense that can move the ball quickly, and they don't have the explosiveness to hit you. You know, in a 1 or 2 minute touchdown drive, they don't have the, you know, the athletes to get the big play, so you really have to come up with a stop here.
Second and goal. Call it the 5 yard line. Wildcat, Matthews directly to him. Barrels his way down to the goal line. Waiting for a signal, and there it is. Touchdown. So the direct snap to Matthews for 6.
It's going to look like they have him stop short of the goal line, but watch the lower body strength. I think that's a touchdown. I think he just got the football.
Was the knee down?
He did a nice job keeping. Let's see, you're not, it's not down yet there.
Oh, he kept that right knee.
He kept
somehow.
His knee. I mean, that lower body strength to keep tacklers.
In his play, he's under further review.
And to keep, I mean, he did on the play that he got injured in the first half. He made that same type of play where he's falling forward and he's not letting those knees touch and he's picking up extra yards.
That's, I mean, how does he keep the knee off the ground that low? But he does, and the ball breaks the plane. So they'll take, you knew they would take a closer look.
Yeah, let's see if we can freeze it right about there. And see, he keeps the knee. I mean, it looks there like he keeps that knee.
The previous
above
angle.
Above grass level.
We had, you knew he kept it above.
Let's take a look from the other angle.
Yeah, that's a great look.
Right here. And that's just tremendous lower body strength. I mean, it's hard to tell. He's playing in the WAC, but he's playing against top-notch competition. You know, Pat Hill says that he's the best that he's ever seen at Fresno State since 97. Long tenure for Pat Hill up in Fresno. And that's saying a lot. I mean, there have been some good backs that have played at Fresno State over the last decade or so.
Yeah, in the paper this week, in fact, they ran a series where they asked the number of former players, and to a person that I saw, they said Ryan Matthews the best that we've seen. 111
After
yards.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
Yep.
Yeah, and when they confirm it, they saw visual evidence that indeed the knee didn't touch the turf. If it's a situation where they can't reverse the call, it isn't indisputable, but they didn't know for sure, they'll say that the call stands.
It's a good clarification. So semantically speaking, you're much better in English than Spanish. That's what you're saying here.
I hope so.
Gessling on for the extra point. And it's up and good. So Fresno State now starting to take control here in the fourth.
Twenty-seven consecutive bowls.
12 conference titles.
And two T-bones.
My man.
Hot Bobby. Oh, Hot Bobby.
The more you save on insurance, the more you'll have for football. Are you in good hands?
Daggone. Daggone.
Lady, get out.
Hey, lady. This is no time to play. I'm picking a photo for my Capital One credit card. Old man Sutter. Why would I put his picture on my card? Nice drawing, but this photo's cuter.
Personalize your card by uploading your own photo at CapitalOne.com.
Lady, what's in your wallet?
911, what's your emergency?
What do I get my wife?
Does she email, text, and call her friends like every waking minute?
Yes, she does.
Get a smartphone. That's a cinch.
And when you come in,
we'll hook you up that day
so you can walk out working
and she can text away.
Yay. You guys rock.
Yeah, we do.
Smartphones, plans, and no annoying mail-in rebates. The best gifts come from Best Buy.
They're running the men's room marathon.
With lots of guys going over and over.
And here's the dash to the men's room with lots of guys going urgently.
And then there's the night game.
Waking up to go.
These guys should be in a race to see their doctors.
Right. Those could be urinary symptoms due to BPH, an enlarged prostate.
But for many guys, prescription Flomax reduces their urinary symptoms due to BPH in 1 week.
Only your doctor can tell if you have BPH, not a more serious condition like prostate cancer.
When taking Flomax, avoid driving or hazardous tasks until you know how Flomax will affect you, as a sudden drop in blood pressure may occur, rarely resulting in fainting.
Tell your doctor about all medications you take. If considering cataract surgery, tell your eye surgeon you've taken Flomax.
Common side effects are runny nose, dizziness, and decrease in semen.
Ask your doctor if Flomax is right for you.
Call 877-4-FLOMAX to see if you qualify for up to $40 off new or refill prescriptions.
For many men, Flomax can make a difference in 1 week.
It's time now for a bowl update brought to you by Flomax. As the steady stream of bowls continues tonight in St. Petersburg, UCF and Rutgers, a pair of 8-4 teams, will collide in the St. Petersburg Bowl. UCF closed pretty strong. They won 5 out of 6 to finish the season. Sound team, don't beat themselves. They play good defense to try to make Rutgers one-dimensional. Scarlet Knights have a big play offense when Tim Brown is healthy, but he's been nursing a hamstring, so you got to keep an eye on that situation tonight. Mohamed Sanu is a very talented freshman. He'll be asked to step in and fill the void if Brown's not 100%. So Rutgers and UCF coming up 8 o'clock Eastern tonight from St. Petersburg. David, Terry.
All right, Chris, look forward to that one. Still more time here in the fourth. in Albuquerque. There's your trophy right there, David Norrie.
Pretty impressive.
They do that by hand every year. It's a different one every year, and it's made in the design of the Bulldogs and the Cowboys with their designs on them this year. The interception and the strike to the end zone for Fresno State, an 11-point lead. Gage Carraway brings it back and just drilled out at the 33-yard line. Hops right up, though. Brought it back 29 yards. It was the kicker, Andrew Shapiro, was all pumped up about being in on that. So Wyoming goes to work on offense now from the 32. See, when you're a kicker, you get a chance to do that. That's cool.
I'm not sure who made the hit and who absorbed the hit there, but he was all gacked up.
Austin Carter Samuels hands it off. They're going to run it this way. Alexander breaks through in a good gain. First down out to the 47-yard line. Gain of 15. And an important drive, to say the least, if Wyoming is going to make a comeback. They came back in four games in the fourth quarter, comeback wins this year. Including their final win against Colorado State, but they've been shut down for the most part, just 17 rushing yards here in the second half. On the ground again. This time it's Brandon Stewart and into Fresno State territory.
Well, Wyoming had to win their rivalry game against Colorado State, the Bronze Boot. And that was a couple weeks back. And Carter Samuels put together two big-time drives, including a 49-yard touchdown run early in the fourth quarter. And he's going to need some more of that here if they're going to come back against Fresno State.
And then Stewart back in the backfield with Carter Samuels. Looks for room, looks for a hole, nothing doing. Sent backwards. Chris Carter was there. Chase McEntee also in on it.
Well, there's an element of responsibility for a defense when you go up against a spread offense like this with the zone read and all your responsibilities. But the best way for a defense to slow down a spread offense is to beat people at the line of scrimmage, man to man. And here in the second half, Terry, the difference is this defensive front is very athletic, and they are just flat out beating this offensive line mano a mano.
Big third down coming up. Four receivers to the far side. Play action. They don't get the play off as flags come up.
False start. 72 offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
So they'll back them up for third down. Mentioned it, four fourth quarter comebacks this season for Wyoming.
Hey, look at the San Diego State game. Watts hit the kick to win that ball game. He also had the big kick against Colorado State, a kick that Wyoming had to have to get into a bowl game.
And that one-point win over Colorado State, John Fletcher with a big block of an extra point earlier in that game. The difference. Now to Samuel. Nowhere to go. Guns it over the middle of the field. He's got his man. Complete inside the 30-yard line. Zach Bolger, the junior from Casper, Wyoming, with a big catch.
Well, Dave Christensen is very excited that he's going to have this quarterback for the next 3 years. How about the movement and the toughness in the pocket? Buying time, and Bolger does what you need from your wide receiver. He's running full speed. He's trying to catch your vision as a quarterback, get in your range of vision, and he runs away from the defender. Big play between quarterback and wide receiver.
Hand off to Alexander. Looks to get around the edge. Does. Big hole inside the 15 down to the 12. They're not done yet. 11 minutes left in this one in Wyoming. Knocking on the door.
Terry, you know, we talked to the Wyoming coaching staff, and how many times did they tell us this week, whenever we needed a big play, whenever we've been in trouble this year, Carter Samuels has got us a big play. And this is a must-have drive. Wyoming can get right back in this football game.
Brandon Stewart, the tailback. First and 10 from the 12. Stewart, patient, fights his way close to the 10. And maybe better than advertised, Austin Curtis Samuels as a true freshman. And they were ranked eighth in the conference in passing this year, but several times today we've seen that this guy's got an arm on him and got some presence in the pocket.
Well, he originally committed to Dick Tomey out at San Jose State and decommitted, and I really like his arm strength.
Quick throw as he's hit. Leonard to the end zone, touchdown. Austin Curtis Samuels barely got that one off.
Well, this was a drive that really was a must-have drive for Wyoming, and a beautifully executed play. Leonard getting inside. He's been the big play wide receiver for the Cowboys all year long. And at 28-23, I think this is a good time to go for two for Wyoming. Deep enough into a game, and if you got 4 or 5 minutes left in the third quarter, maybe you go ahead and kick the extra point. I like going for two here.
Fresno State late getting people on the field. They finally do. They're trying to make it a three-point game. Looking, throwing, got his man. It is a three-point game. Greg Bowling on the catch.
And Bowling's just going to get inside his defender. And again, how about the ability moving to the right and throwing an inside route, coming back to the left? I mean, Terry, there are not many quarterbacks in college football that have that type of athleticism to move around in the pocket, throw the ball on the roll. This is a true freshman.
Leonard, 11 yards to the end zone. The two-point tacked on. And it's 28-25.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
I'm right here.
And I always will be.
Now you can surround her with the strength of Love's Embrace, new from K Jewelers. One more reason K is the number one jewelry store in America.
Every kiss begins with K.
The extreme power of Energizer Ultimate Lithium, the world's longest lasting AA battery and high-tech devices. Energizer, keep going.
No matter what goes down, recovery will fix you up. And get a fix on the hangover. Buy it on Blu-ray and DVD.
Itchy dry scalp? Could be your shampoo. Now there's a new Selsun Blue just for itchy dry scalp. Strong itch fighters target the source of scalp itch, while 5 moisturizers keep hair healthy.
No more itch.
New Selsun Blue Itchy Dry Scalp.
Got a clue? Get the blue.
Do you have an idea for an invention or a new product? Bill Schaefer, co-inventor of the Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play. InventHelp submitted his idea to WAMO, makers of toys like the Frisbee and the Hula Hoop. Hi, I'm Clarence McGee, the sales director of InventHelp. To find out how we can help you try to submit your idea to companies, call for your free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain with his invention. Bill's experience is not typical, and most inventions are not successful.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-361-0086.
NewMexico.org.
ESPN College Football, the New Mexico Bowl, is brought to you by the Albuquerque Convention and Visitors Bureau. Visit us at itsatrip.org.
We're not quite done yet. Wyoming with an impressive drive to stay in this thing in the fourth quarter. The fourth annual New Mexico Bowl from Albuquerque. It's 28-25 Fresno State. More from his own 15. Breaking it back this way. Brought down at the 48 of Wyoming. He almost broke it all the way. Marlon Moore. Big time return of almost 40 yards.
Well, since Pat Hill arrived in 97, Fresno State has been one of the best special teams groups in the country. You know, going back to 97, Pat Hill's teams have scored 42 times on special teams. Three of those have been safeties. 39 touchdowns from a special teams unit.
You know, you throw those numbers out, and then but you really reflect on it. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, it is amazing. There are teams that have scored maybe four or five times over that period in college football.
First down, Fresno State. Ryan Matthews breaking through. This side looks to cut back. Still up. And run out of bounds finally at the 36-yard line. And a gain of 12 for Matthews, who's gone over 100 yards now in 11 games this season. But go back to that last drive for Wyoming, David. It's a time of the ball game where you can say, all right, maybe Fresno State's taking over. They didn't. I mean, that's a big-time drive.
It is a big-time drive. And let's face it, Dave Christensen's offense, he was at Missouri. He had Chase Daniel. This is a quarterback offense. They want to spread you out, throw the ball all over the field. I think he has a quarterback that can get that done in the next two or three years for Wyoming, and he's got to really be excited about his true freshman.
And maybe that drive is much about inside, guts, not giving up, as it is about X's and O's.
Well, if you're going to play quarterback, as Fresno State continues to go heavily to Ryan Matthews and chew up yards, it's a big drive for the Bulldogs. But if you're going to have a quarterback in that spread offense, he's got to be very good in terms of moving around in the pocket, escaping the rush, buying time, and then letting multiple receivers, you know, modify their routes off of broken routes, just as Bolger did on the big play on that last drive.
Second down. And four from the 31. Damo Payao in motion, trying to throw a block from Matthews. Nothing doing. At the line of scrimmage. Held right there. John Fletcher in on the stop. And think about this, too. Another aspect of this game being here in Albuquerque. We're over 5,200 feet in elevation. If you're from Laramie, it's not going to bother you. If you're from Fresno, it may come the fourth quarter as we wind down.
Yeah, and a lot of coaches will try to sub in and out frequently, especially in the first half, so that they don't get that gas tank spent with some of their players, especially their running backs.
Big third down. Out of the eye, they go to number 21. Matthews hit, but falls ahead and has a first down. Ball came loose, but they're going to say he was down. And Wyoming players pleading their case.
Well, the umpire was not calling the ball loose, but this would be.
Oh, that's loose.
It is loose. And you know what? This is going to be Wyoming football. What a play by Mitch Unrein.
He took it right away from him. Now the officials are huddling and having a discussion.
Well, they might call it Wyoming's ball on the field here, but if they don't, it's going to go upstairs in a hurry.
Well, with that second look, there's no question. Unrein took it right away.
Yeah, the only question is if by chance a knee was down, but I don't think so.
Ruling on the field. The runner was down prior to the fumble. First down.
Well, this is why you have replay. And keep in mind, every play is reviewed at the college level. I don't even think a challenge will be needed here, Terry.
Well, in our first look, it was apparent pretty soon that ball's out. And they're actually showing it on the big screen right now, and that's what Christensen's pointing to.
Well, now, the ball was loose and was on the turf, and Wyoming clearly came up with the recovery. You know, still you could review it. I can't believe that the ball's going to be snapped here. And
yeah,
it's not.
It can't. There's no way. And actually, you saw the expression.
The previous play is under further review.
And read the lips of Dave Christensen, who was saying the same thing.
Well, and as I was saying, Terry, if the ball's loose and Wyoming clearly comes up with it, even if it's on the turf, well, then you can review it and it can be Wyoming's ball. In that situation, Unrein stripped it and had it in his possession. The ball never hit the turf. What a play.
So it's under official review with 8:08. That's a big play coming up. Big decision when we come back.
Join Boomer and the gang for Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
What can you do when you have a rich, unique blend of culture, cuisine, and climate all in one amazing place? You can do it all.
To plan your trip to Albuquerque, visit itsatrip.org.
This holiday, experience the world of Polo Ralph Lauren fragrances. The passion, the tradition, the world of Polo Ralph Lauren fragrances. Holiday gift collection at Macy's.
Eat chicken wings, buy Hooters things. Christmas is near, shop, have a beer. Christmas shopping shouldn't be hard. Simply buy a Hooters gift card. Eat chicken wings, buy Hooters things. Shop where it's cool, right from your stool. Magazines, calendars, great caps. Gifts so cool they will not need wraps. Eat chicken wings, buy Hooters things. Christmas is near, your friends are here. Get yourself to Hooters right now to buy the gifts for those you want to wow. Hooters gifts are always favored.
What's up?
My jersey.
My laptop.
My baseball.
My cell phone.
My basketball.
Jared!
What's that?
Skinit.com. Go there now.
At Skinit.com, you choose your IT device and your passion, and we skin it for you. Skinit.com.
Jared!
You dream it.
After an official review, the ruling upstairs is that it is Wyoming football. It was a fumble, obviously, and the Cowboys come up with it.
Yeah, and this is Mitch Unrein, and watch him work. This is a beautiful strip of the football. He keeps at it, gets off the block, the strip of the football. And even with the whistle, even if the ball's blown dead, and I love the rule change this year in college football, if it's clear that the other team comes up with the football, then it can be reviewed and it can be reversed.
I don't think the officials ever knew that the ball changed hands. And there was no scramble for it, and that's why they were shocked to see number 98 say, hey, I took it away. First down. Curtis Samuels has some room. Stiff arm, run out of bounds at the 27-yard line. A short gain. And pushed out there by Phillip Thomas, the backup strong safety. So it brings up second down. And remember, you know, you talk about big plays in this game. Coming in, Wyoming had a much better turnover margin than Fresno State. And that, those are updated numbers.
Well, it was a mismatch on paper coming into the game. Fresno State and their potent offense, and the Wyoming coaching staff knew they would need some mistakes, some turnovers from the Bulldogs, and they have received them.
Two big fumbles caused by this Wyoming defense. Second and nine out of the shotgun. True freshman stepping up. Hit hard, fights up to the 32. And Jacobs there on the stop, had some help.
Those turnovers become bigger when you're up against your own goal line or when you're in scoring position. And for Fresno State, they were in the red zone in the first half on the fumble, the problem on the handoff between Miller and Colburn. And, you know, they're getting close to being in the red zone on that last drive.
We hit the 7-minute mark, and how big was that 2-point conversion, too, to get them within three? Alexander running the other way. Can he get around the edge? Powers his way, but short of a first down. Ran right into Sean Plummer. You know, Vester, who had the 68-yard touchdown run early in the game and has gone over 100 yards, had to work for those.
Now, Chris Lewis has had himself a ball game, moving outside. The defensive tackle who had to move outside for Kenny Borg in the bowl game today. Chris Carter, the left defensive end, gets all the publicity, but Lewis has been all over the field, and he has been hounding Curtis Samuels and Alexander throughout the afternoon.
And you can't think about this one. Fourth and two, but you're at the 34. So punt it away and hope your defense can make another stop. They're going to throw it on the fake, caught, and that's a first down. Just past the sticks. What a play, what a gamble, what a catch by David Leonard to fight for the first down. Austin McCoy, the punter who threw it. How about that, Mr. Norrie?
Well, you talk about rolling the dice. And this isn't an easy throw. This is going to be Leonard, and he's going to creep out in the flat. And how about this throw? I mean, it's not exactly like Leonard was running free in the secondary there, and a beautiful ball leading him. They just pick up the first down.
And Leonard on the concentration, too, to make the catch. Stewart hurdling tacklers across the 40. Take another look.
How many punters? That's a pretty nice ball, too. The tight little spiral. Talk about a punter putting the ball right on the money. That's what I love about the bowl season. You're kicking it off, and you see those decisions, and, you know, you can take your chances.
Maybe make some calls you wouldn't normally make. They set up that screen over the middle, complete at the 44-yard line. Just about Travis Burkhalter, his second catch of the day. As we approach the five-minute mark.
Now, with the exception of Carter Samuels getting outside the pocket, buying time, and allowing receivers to get down the field, you get the feel that Wyoming just doesn't have a lot of ability and vertical threat down the field in the passing game. They're throwing short routes or throwing wide receiver screens. They got to patch together these drives.
All three timeouts left for Wyoming as we come up to a third and a long two. Pressure on the quarterback, near sideline, incomplete. It's not a high percentage play. Greg Bowling, outstretched hands for that, but no chance. Sean Plummer was the first man in on Carter Samuels. He wasn't the only one, though.
He was working against Deesha Dunn. And you're right, Terry, that is not. Wow, how about the shot? At the gut. Sean Plummer with a helmet shot under the chin. But that is not a high percentage throw, and it looks like Wyoming's going for it here on fourth down. You know what? I like the call.
Well, now you're inside 5 minutes, 4.5 minutes. Your field position's a little bit different than the last time, and they're 2 for 2 on fourth down today.
You certainly wouldn't be wrong going either way here. I mean, if you punt the football away, you still have three timeouts.
Timeout.
This is a difficult decision. But in a bowl game from your own 45, you make decisions that you might not make in a regular season game, and this could be one of them.
So they'll talk things over on the sideline. As a former quarterback at UCLA and a guy who knows clock management very well, if you're Dave Christensen, you've got a true freshman at quarterback trying to win this on the final drive. You can't assume that he's going to know much in terms of making those decisions by himself on the field right now.
Well, and what I like about going for it here is even if you don't make it, you still have three timeouts. There's still 4.5 minutes to go in the game. And Fresno State isn't even in field goal range at this point. It's a three-point game. So you're going to have to stop Fresno State either way you go. Why not take a shot at picking up the first down and not having to give the ball back to Fresno State?
You burn this timeout, so now you've got two timeouts the rest of the way down.
Right.
But you're near midfield, so you don't have that far to go. And again, the two-point conversion was big because now you're within three and you're just trying to set up a field goal.
Yeah, and again, plenty of time, 4.5 minutes. It's just a matter of I like to try to keep the ball, keep possession here. And then if you don't pick it up, you're still in the football game.
Fourth down. 2 for 2 on the afternoon so far for the Cowboys. Curtis Samuels looking for a lane. Keeps it, has the first down. Across the 50 to the 47, he spins. And a gain of 8.
Yeah, he certainly is a smooth athlete. I mean, watch the way that he glides here, gets the ball upfield, turns it inside. And he's one of those quarterbacks that's very difficult for defenders to draw beads on him, and he has been so good all game long with his legs.
Plenty of time as we approach the 4 minute mark. Alexander driving the legs, doesn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Chance to remind you, Capital One Bowl Week continues Tuesday. Two teams ranked in the top 20. This should be a good one. Oregon State against BYU, number 18 against number 14, the Mako Bowl, Las Vegas. BYU knows all about that bowl. Oregon State, a close loss at Oregon, close out the season.
Couple big-time quarterbacks statistically in that game this year. Max Hall, Sean Canfield.
Quick throw, backwards pass. Burkhalter looking to throw it initially and throws it away now. That's a good decision. No one down there.
Yeah, and I think they were looking for Alexander, the tailback, up the field. And he did not get downfield in time. That's a very heady play by Burkhalter to go ahead and throw the football away on this play. Okay, here's a tailback, and he's going to get down the football field. This is an interesting play design. See how he delays in the backfield, and he's going to get down the field. That ball, you know, Burkhalter faced pressure. He wasn't able to get the ball out. It would have had to come out early.
He may have had him. I'm not sure he had the arm strength either to throw it where he needed to throw it. Third and 10. Room to run initially, at least. Hesitation knocked out just outside the 40, or brought down at least.
Now, this is a foregone conclusion after we just saw this. The decision to go for it on the last fourth down situation.
But it's not fourth and two now, it's fourth and four. So it brings up a different challenge.
Yeah, but the field position here predicates that you have to go for it.
No, I'm not saying you don't go for it, but
yeah.
It's a short.
Well, absolutely, Terry, and agree. It's a different play call potentially, but I wouldn't be surprised if we do see Carter Samuels keep his hands on the football once again, or at least have a run pass threat. I think that's the way that you try to pick up the first down in this situation. I don't think you take the ball out of Carter Samuel's hands unless he's throwing it.
They burn their second timeout, so Wyoming down to one timeout. We've got a moment, so let's send it back to the studio. And Chris.
Terry, thank you, and congratulations to Wisconsin Whitewater. The Warhawks win the Division III National Championship against their arch rivals, Mount Union. This is a touchdown run by Lavelle Coppedge after the Purple Raiders had tied it at 28. 38-28 is the final. So for the second time in 3 years, Whitewater, champions of Division III, the fifth consecutive meeting between these teams in the championship game. Up next on Bowl Week, Mohamed Sanu and Rutgers, de facto road team against UCF in the St. Petersburg Bowl. Back for this wild finish, guys.
All right, Chris, Whitewater, Norrie's sleeper pick. 3 minutes left here in Albuquerque, the fourth New Mexico Bowl. Kicking off Capital One Bowl Week, and a good one as we come down to another fourth down play for the Cowboys. Fourth and four at the 41. Quick throw, Leonard. Did he make the catch? He did. Another first down. David Leonard. And a gain of six.
Now, David Leonard has been money for Wyoming throughout the season. You look on offense, you know, Alexander has been developing as a playmaker, a tailback, but Leonard is the guy that they've gone to when they've needed big plays in the pass game, and that was a huge conversion.
That's just making a play when you have to have it. Place it down at the 35. Stewart looking for a block. He's going to lose yardage and drop out at the 41. Travis Brown was the first man in there. And Kyle Knox has had a big game defensively.
Well, Fresno State has done a great job of not allowing Wyoming to get to the corner, to get to the edge here in the second half. And they've had multiple defenders getting up into the alleyways. And when you miss on a play like that and you lose 6-7 yards on first down, that really creates problems on a game-winning drive.
Four receivers to the near side. Alexander in the backfield along with Carter Samuel. Quick throw to Leonard up in the air, and a dangerous play. That ball was tipped and could have been picked off. Don't forget, coming up after our game, St. Petersburg Bowl presented by Beef O'Brady's. ESPN News will have post-game extra on our matchup here. And ESPN360.com will have the trophy ceremony live.
Excellent play by Philip Thomas reading that inside screen and almost created a turnover.
After that initial five-yard loss on first down, third and almost 16. Carter Samuels almost fell, throws back, complete, Bolger the catch inside the 30 and close to the 20-yard line. They'll move the chains again. 20 yards on the play. And how about Curtis Samuels as a true freshman with the presence to keep his poise in the pocket and out of it?
Well, I love quarterbacks that are accurate when they're moving. And Curtis Samuels has made the big plays on the move. Oftentimes with pass rushers bearing down on him. Nice job by Bolger to wait after the catch there. Leonard coming downfield to help him with a big block from the wide receiver position.
And now you're in field goal range and you get greedy. You want the six for the win. They'll keep it on the ground though. Alexander right to the line of scrimmage. Logan Harrell on the stop. Remember, Wyoming with one timeout. Fresno State has two.
Well, and you want to make sure that you don't turn the football over here. You tell your ball carriers and receivers, make sure that you're holding on to the football. And Wyoming with only one timeout left, they have to be cognizant of the clock here. Don't take any chances. Curtis Samuel has been very safe with the football throughout this game.
David, how about this? The 17th play of the drive. Second and 10 under pressure. Here comes the blitz. He throws it away. And fortunate to get rid of that one. Don't forget Monday night, NFC East battle in Washington. Eli Manning and the Giants taking on the Redskins. 8:30 Eastern time. Monday night countdown served by Applebee's. Comes up earlier at 7 o'clock Eastern. All right, third and 10 with 30 seconds to go here in Albuquerque.
Well, Wyoming's done a nice job, and I'm not sure it was by design, but they've done a nice job not leaving ticks on the clock for Fresno State. If by chance Wyoming can get a field goal here or a touchdown. But again, not exactly a comfortable field goal attempt.
They'll blow the whistle. They don't get this one off. Wyoming took the timeout. And it is their final timeout as we step away and come back in a moment.
NewMexico.org.
Oh, thank goodness you're back.
What's going on, sir?
We're slammed. Tons of people interested in all the money they could be saving by switching to Geico.
Yeah, of course.
Boy, did we miss you last week. That temp wasn't working out at all.
Took me all morning, but I got those quarterly figures for you.
Oh, he ate all my mints.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
If you ever make international calls, only Vonage gives you unlimited calling in the U.S. and around the world for just $24.99. Introducing Vonage World. Call 877-4-VONAGE today. Then call India, all of India, or Brazil, all of Brazil. In fact, call all corners of over 60 countries free. And now, sign up by December 31st and get 1 month free. Don't wait. Call 877-4-VONAGE or go to Vonage.com and start saving.
McDonald's Big Mac Avatar Thrill Card brings you more. Take your card to McDonald's.com/avatar and prepare to be thrilled.
You love watching sports in high def. Isn't it time you watch movies the same way?
Yeah, I was just thinking it.
Experience Inglourious Basterds on Blu-ray High Def.
How fun!
In the 2-disc special edition for a limited time only. Now, at a great low price.
Be enchanted. NewMexico.org.
You know, Terry, right here, let's take a look at why Wyoming had to burn their last time out, and it was a bad time to do it. This is Zach Bolger, and watch his indecision here as he tries to decide whether he's going to be one of the 11 on the field for Wyoming or whether he needs to get off the field. He's back and forth. Now watch him. He's going to slip here. That is tough to use your last timeout. Now, it's not catastrophic. You got 30 seconds on the clock. If Wyoming doesn't pick up the first down, or even if they do pick up the first down, plenty of time to get a team on the field or the field goal unit on the team.
So it's third and 10 from the 20. Curtis Samuels out of the shotgun. Alexander in the backfield with him. thrown to the end zone. The receiver fell down. And no contact. Bowling was there. He had a step. Couldn't keep his footing.
Yeah, and I think the legs got tangled there. And that was A.J. Jefferson on the coverage. Not enough to call, but you see, oh boy, if he was able to just keep his balance and keep his deep speed, I think that's six.
So it'll be a 37-yard try for Ian Watts, who's had three game winners this year. As Pat Hill watches. Down, up, and good. And we are tied at 28. And that man right there, a true freshman from Philadelphia, an unrecruited walk-on. Well, what a year he has had.
Yeah, he came into the game 10 for 11 on the year. Field goals against San Diego State and Colorado State that were really the difference between getting into a bowl game, getting Dave Christensen into the holidays with the Cowboys.
And the man who caused that fumble, you remember, he took it right away from Ryan Matthews, Mitch Unrein, to start that lengthy drive. 19 plays, 54 yards, almost 8 minutes off the clock, and a field goal to tie it up.
How about the play of Curtis Samuels, the quarterback? I mean, he has been beautiful in the way he has taken his team down the field. Big drives here in the fourth quarter. Moving around, finding receivers down the field. He's been deadly accurate.
All right, so 20 seconds left in regulation. Not done yet. This is a short kick. A.J. Jefferson watches it go right by him. Moore gets there and falls at the 11. If Marlon Moore wasn't backing up Jefferson, that could have been a disaster.
Yeah, that was big, because if Fresno State can get some sort of return there, get the ball out to the 35, out near midfield, you know, then all of a sudden you've got two timeouts. You had 19, 20 seconds on the clock. You're able to hit a couple balls and get in position for a game winner if you're Pat Hill. And you've got your own field goal kicker who's had a tremendous year. Now I think we're going to see the Bulldogs go to a knee here, and I think we're headed to overtime.
Yeah, you got a center fielder basically back at the 1 yard line. And Colburn will take a knee, and we will head to overtime.
And you do that because of risk reward. There's a shot you could hit a couple balls and you have a couple timeouts, but more bad things can happen than good things there down underneath the shadow of your own goalpost.
There's that young quarterback, Austin Curtis Samuels, the Mountain West Freshman of the Year. And today, getting a good look at why he was named that at the end of the regular season. So we're not done yet. 28 all. We head to overtime here at the New Mexico Bowl and send it back to Chris Fowler in the studio.
All right, Terry, thank you. Why not start off bowl season with an overtime game with those gritty pokes? Up next, Brett Hodges, who came on at quarterback for UCF in the middle of the season as they take on Rutgers in the St. Petersburg Bowl. But let's get back to overtime in Albuquerque, guys.
Hi, Chris. So not many thought we would head to overtime here in this matchup today, Mr. Norrie. Those people did, they believed at least. How about the big plays here in the fourth quarter?
Well, it was a play by Mitch Unrein on the fumble, the strip, and then how about the fake punt? Then came the fourth down conversions. Curtis Samuels turning it upfield, pass to Leonard, and then Watts. Icy with the game on the line.
Three game winners and now one to send it to overtime in the bowl game. But 19 plays on that final drive. That, you know, should they end up winning this game, a lot of people in Laramie are going to remember that drive for a long, long time.
Quite a few Cowboy fans that have shown up for this game, and they've been pretty vocal. Fresno State always travels well from the Valley.
You have to go for 2 points on the play. Any questions, Ben? Fresno, what's your choice? for the coin toss?
Tails is called. There's the head, there's the tail. I'll let it fall on the ground. Heads it is, your choice. You want to play defense. What end of the field do you want to play in? Okay, down that way. First down.
So advantage Wyoming.
Did you hear Weston Johnson? They said, what's your decision? He goes, we want to be on defense.
Well, he wants to be there for more than one reason. He's on defense. But here, again, the overtime rules from the 25-yard line, one possession after that coin toss. And no game clock, obviously. The play clock only. You must go for two, starting with the third overtime.
And remember, Fresno State, they played a two overtime game earlier this season with a pretty good ball club out of the Big Ten, Wisconsin. And you know, you have to be careful when you're playing quarterback and when you're handling the football. A defensive touchdown means the game's over, regardless of who's on offense. A defensive touchdown means we're done.
Matthews with 133 yards on the ground today. All right, first down from the 25. Fresno State with the possession on offense first. Matthews breaks through the initial and brought down at the 22. I know he's got 133 plus yards, but this Cowboy defense done a pretty good job against him.
That's a pretty nice safety blanket there, the security blanket, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, your first play in the overtime, you say, you know what, let's give the ball to Ryan Matthews.
There's a shock.
Yeah, you know, no one's going to argue with that play call.
A gain of three. Matthews, the lone setback, pretty deep. Quick throw. Handler looks to make a move inside the 20. Nice tackle. At the 19. Handler's got six catches on the afternoon, but Deshaun Gibson made a nice play staying right with him.
Yeah, that was a nice play. And a nice ball. That looks like an easy ball from Colburn, but Colburn got it out quickly and gave Handler the football in good shape to take the ball upfield.
So it's third and three. And Ryan Matthews in the Wildcat now. They go with a direct snap. They did it earlier in the game, scored a touchdown. He's going to take it straight ahead. Bounces close.
I think he got it.
And he did. All right, so they went to that earlier in the game, just outside the 5-yard line. He got the touchdown, and now a big first down picked up by Matthews.
And the Wildcat has become so prevalent, not only college, but in the pros. And what it does is it gives you the extra blockers. Now you're 11 on 11 as opposed to 10 on 11.
Renard Camp, the fullback, just ahead of Matthews, out of the eye. Ryan the call again. Bounces off of Camp to the outside. And down to the 10. You know, you see him come out often throughout a game. And Lanye Miller, Robbie Rouse, I'm not sure you're going to see number 21 on the sideline here in overtime.
They did give Rouse a carry to open up the drive against Illinois on the final drive of the game, but they got 21 right back in the game. Look at the arms and the build on number 21. He is a solid back. I love his ability to test between the tackles and bounce it like he did on that last play. We haven't seen the big run out of him. Coming into this game, more 50-yard plus runs than any back in the country.
Second down, quick drop, throw incomplete. Timing was there, but just outside the reach of Sayi Ashiratutu.
And on that ball, you'd like to take a little bit off it, but I can't blame Colburn. You float a ball out in the flat, and Gibson makes a hard break on it. This football game's over. So you have to put a couple extra revolutions on it. You have to put some velocity on it. And if you don't throw the ball with perfect accuracy, there's not much room for the wide receiver to make the adjustment.
Interesting that they chose to throw on second down after picking up four on first down. Now you're forced into a third and six situation.
Wyoming continuing to pack the box on defense.
Matthews in the slot. Look to him initially. Colburn gonna run inside the five, fighting his way down near the goal line. And just short. They'll call it the one. Good decision. good run from Ryan Colburn.
Well, we saw this down the stretch at Illinois. He made some great plays, you know, pulling the football down, throwing the ball on the run. And he doesn't always look athletic when he tucks it. But how about that play? Eluding the pass rush and then pretty tough finishing off that run.
First and goal from the one. You think number 21 might get a call here? Stop, though, short of the goal line. Josh Bazunes helped trip him up. Yes, it is Bazunes, B-I-E-Z-U-N-S.
And Bazunes is going to come from the top of the screen, and it's going to come all the way across the face of the play and track Matthews down from behind.
And Matthews now has Camp ahead of him out of the eye. Second and goal. Going to try it again. Fights close.
I don't think you got
it. He didn't get it. No signal, and he stopped short two consecutive times. Weston Johnson stopped him there. So it's third and goal.
Valiant effort by Wyoming up front to get penetration. Ball not breaking the plane. I think it's a good time maybe to take your quarterback Colburn and get behind Joe Bernardi. Your big center, two-year starter. Guy who's been pretty darn good in his career, and I like sneak here.
So they offset Camp and Matthews now on third and goal. Colburn, he does sneak it, fights his way. Stopped initially. And again, no signal. And apparently did not get there.
Well, and he didn't follow his center up into the hole. You know, he took a step back and he tested the right guard area. I don't like, as a quarterback, you know, stepping backwards or laterally. You got to get that initial push.
Well, how good is this stand here? Fourth and goal coming up for Fresno State.
And watch Colburn here. I mean, I think he gets some room and he can go over the top there, but he decides to test the right guard. Sometimes that's by design, but that gave Wyoming a chance to get some penetration, and big fourth down coming up.
Alex Stover, the man down right now and injured in the end zone. Sophomore from Gretna, Nebraska. So it's fourth and goal. Watch this again from the goal line.
Yeah, these situations are all about toughness and really who wants it more. Who's going to get off the ball quickly with good pad level. And I just don't like retreating. Even if it's just for a half a count there as a quarterback, I like getting the snap and getting north-south. Wyoming doing their best here to potentially, you know, turn Fresno State away, and then all of a sudden all you need is a field goal to win.
And that whole decision of when do I kick that and put three on the board? I can't come away with nothing. But you're at the, no, you're inside the one. You're at about the 3-inch line.
And this isn't a decision for Pat Hill. You go here from the half yard line, and
but you've been stopped three consecutive plays twice, handing the ball off to the leading rusher in the nation in yards per game.
Stover walking off gingerly here. It also forces your hand a little bit in terms of the play call coming up on fourth down, because, you know, you try quarterback sneak again, and I still like quarterback sneak here. I think if you can't score on quarterback sneak from the half yard line, you know, that says something about you up front. But you just got turned away on third down. And you got Ryan Matthews in the backfield.
I think you give it to Matthews. If I got Ryan, I know he's been stopped twice. What are the chances of three times in four tries?
Well, Ryan Matthews, it would not be the wrong call. And they're going to get Camp lined up, the big fullback in the backfield, in the eye.
Here we go. Fourth and goal. Colburn. Going to hand it off to Matthews. High into the air. Stopped right there at the goal line. And what a stop defensively for Wyoming. Are you kidding me?
I think it was Bazunes.
Four tries from the one or inside the one, and they can't get there.
And they go to the eye, and They try the blast play, and that was Bazoon's number 44. He comes downhill, and that is a great play by Josh Bazoon's. It looked like Fresno State was going to make it look easy. I mean, they drove the ball down inside the five. Just without much effort. And then all of a sudden, Wyoming absolutely stoned Fresno State on four straight plays.
Think about the drive at the end of regulation for Wyoming. 19 plays, 54 yards, the field goal to tie it. They had three fourth down plays in which they picked it up. And now, first and goal from the one, and they stop Fresno State with nothing on the board. Unbelievable.
Now this is Bazoon's, and watch him come downhill. He's going to get inside, and then he's going to go low on Matthews. And Matthews, once Bazoon's goes low there, Matthews is be able to use second effort. Gabe Napton, a pretty good play from his middle linebacker position to go high on Ryan Matthews. What a goal line stand by Wyoming.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Did not score.
Too much penetration by that defensive front of Wyoming, and Bazoon's got there first. Napton finished him off. Then they deny Ryan Matthews. Three of the four tries there from the one are inside of it. They handed it to number 21. So now the ball is on the side of the Cowboys from the 25.
And it goes over to Wyoming, and now all of a sudden your play calling changes a little bit if you're Wyoming. You don't need seven here. You're thinking field goal, and you're thinking ball security, and you also have to think, you know, we do not want to see a turnover go the other way. That's a way that things can turn around on you in a hurry.
Austin Curtis Samuels taking over. Almost some interference in the backfield there. Almost lost it. Short gain on first down. Chris Carter with the tackle just inside the 25.
And they're already in Watts' range. We talked to Dave Christensen earlier this week, and we asked him, were you comfortable with Mr. Watts? And he said, oh, about the 25-yard line, which equates to about a 42, maybe a 43-yarder. The Cowboys already in field goal position, but they want to get Watts a more comfortable kick here if they can.
Late play called and coming in from the sideline. Going to keep it himself. Curtis Samuels, that's what they're doing here. They're being a little conservative. And inside the 20 as we send it back one more time to Chris Fowler in the studio. Chris.
We're still buzzing here about that epic goal line stand. But up next, Bryn Harvey and the Golden Knights of UCF. He's the guy that ripped up Houston in the win for UCF. They'll take on Rutgers minutes away from St. Pete.
And they're buzzing here still about that goal line stand, Chris.
You don't get many epics out of Chris Fowler.
What a bad stand.
I think Wyoming's going to continue to keep the ball on the ground. I don't think you'll see it in the air here.
Third and five. Not only keeping it on the ground, just taking a knee. Saying, hey, number 51, it's your game to win right now.
Yeah, this is going to be in the neighborhood of about a 40-yarder. And Curtis Samuels getting over to the center of the football field, getting things lined up for Watts. What a game.
From 40 yards, the man who wasn't recruited by anybody, a walk-on. And he pulled it. No good. And we're still tied at 28. And it's back to the stands for the Wyoming fans, just finding your seat again.
Well, and the players and the coaches were rushing the field. And Ian Watts did not hit this. I didn't see the hold, but I thought it was a pretty good hold by Sween. And Watts did not hit that field goal attempt very cleanly.
Celebration had begun already.
Now that was not a good kick.
And he knew it as soon as he hit it.
That's pretty unusual for Watts. He came into the game 10 for 11. He hit the big kick, the clutch kick at the end of regulation. We talked about the kicks against San Diego State and Colorado State. Yeah, that's a nice solid hold. A good snap, a good hold by Sween, and Watts. You know, nerves work on kickers, and I think maybe the nerves were a factor there with Watts on that attempt.
You know, they've kind of joked about it throughout the end of the regular season because he's been so good. Dave Christensen at one point in one of those situations said, doesn't matter if they ice you, just go. This is already made. Go out there and just enjoy this kick. Well, this time, he may have told him the same thing. Different result.
Yeah, it's one of those unusual situations. Fresno State's defense is right back on the field.
Yeah, so now we go to the other end of the field, and the second overtime period begins. And it's Wyoming football to start it.
Now the Cowboys will open things up on offense.
Full receiver set, play action. Curtis Samuels on the run. Looks to the end zone. Talk about opening things up. Incomplete. Bowling was there. Looked like there was a little bit of contact, and the Cowboy fans wanted interference.
That was still a pretty nice throw from Curtis Samuels. Again, I think he's, you know, he's a rare breed in college football, even though this is his first year and he's only about 6 or 7 months out of the lunch line in high school. He's pretty accurate when he gets back and gets set up in the pocket on the timing throws, but he's just as accurate when he's moving, and he put that ball on a pretty nice spot in the end zone.
So it's second and 10 from the 25. No pressure initially, now rushed out and looking, still looking. Tucks it, still up. Flips it out, incomplete. The only way he could get it out there. And he had a man, he had Leonard at about the 15. And just making sure it wasn't going to be intercepted, though.
Well, he has a lot of confidence in his scrambling ability. There were a couple opportunities there for Fresno State to drop him for a big loss. And you looking at a third and 20 or third and 22, your odds of winning the game, they decrease by a large margin. But you look at Dave Christensen, he's got a lot of confidence in his quarterback, too. And you got to hand it to number five. He kept the ball alive, and he lived to fight another day. Had he played to throw the football away?
Yeah, it's one of those situations, too. If you're Ian Watts, and Wyoming will take a timeout, you're kind of right on that fence between wanting another opportunity and not wanting it because you want your team to score a touchdown and to kick the extra point. And also thinking, do I really want to go back out there at this point and try again?
No, the Cowboys don't pick up yards here. They're looking at a 42-yarder, so it would be a longer kick than the one he just missed.
All right, third and 10 coming up when we come back. But back to the studio again, and Chris.
Thanks. Coming up on ESPN next, UCF and Rutgers. That game will begin over on ESPN Classic. So if you don't want to miss the kickoff there, switch over to Classic. If you want to see if the kicker with the Dick Butkus number can redeem himself, keep it right here. Guys, back to you.
Doesn't quite look like Butkus. It hasn't reminded me of one of the all-time greats. But it is number 51. And having a chat with Carsten Sween, who's his holder right now.
Number 51. He's not quite as intimidating. The presence, I'll give Chris that.
All 175 pounds of him. They're at the St. Petersburg Bowl starting right now, but coming up next, presented by Beefo Brady's, when we are done. Third and 10 here in the second overtime period. Play action. Stepping up, Curtis Samuels thrown to the end zone and contact down there, and that you do get a flag now. Bowling was held right at the goal line. Phillip Thomas, who's done a pretty nice job staying with him, had a hold of him.
And this is basically
defensive pass interference. Number 16 on the defense. Half the distance. First down.
This is a case of the wide receiver having his eyes back to the football and Thomas, the defender, not getting his eyes to the ball. And you know what? That's a pretty tough call there. If Thomas would not have had his hands on the receiver there.
Defensive pass interference, the full 15 yards.
It's going to be a 15-yard penalty. There wasn't a lot of contact, but Thomas did have both hands on the receiver. And it's unfortunate for Fresno State because that was not going to be a completed ball. Another nice play by Carter Samuels to just get the ball off and allow his wide receiver to make a play or maybe pick up the flag.
But you can't. It was one of those that you can't judge uncatchable because certainly his route was impaired. First and goal, Stewart to the 7. Still fighting as if he's up, but he's brought down at the 7. They whistled it dead there.
Well, if you were not with us for the fourth quarter, you've missed what has been a heck of a hour and a half or so. It's been terrific. Final drive for Wyoming and a field goal to tie it up, send it to overtime. Goal line stand. Fresno State first in goal. 4 straight tries from the 1 or inside the 1. Stopped, and then the field goal missed just moments ago by Ian Watts. So this is where we are. Second and goal, second overtime. Flag down as that one was tipped. Chris Lewis got up in the air. And perhaps a hold, I believe. Yep.
Holding. Number 67, offense. 10-yard penalty. Still second down.
I believe Chris Lewis, number 93, got the tip on this. When you throw routes inside on these... 93 almost swallows up the football there. When you throw the inside routes on the screens and receivers working to the center of the field, that's dangerous. Somebody tips the football, you get a deflection, and that can turn into a turnover in a hurry.
Just about tipped it with his molar. Pretty much in the helmet. That's second and goal from the 18 now. Poise, throws complete, brought down at the 12, bowling the catch.
But a lot of space there. Carter Samuels is a cool customer when the pass rush becomes a factor. And he had a couple Bulldogs in his face. He still was patient enough to let Bowling work across the field on that shallow crossing route. And again, he throws the ball right on the numbers.
Debated all night long whether you're a true freshman at this point in the season. But the fact is, this guy's got 3 more years in Laramie. Experience-wise, doesn't play like it, though. Nobody with him in the backfield. Steps up. Gets out again. Lofts it up for Leonard, who makes the catch. Did he stay in? He did. David Leonard keeping the foot down, holding onto the football, and he gets to the end zone. And Curtis Samuels buying time to get it there.
I mean, this is about as good as it gets when you're talking about a quarterback making a play with the game on the line. And if you're going to do it, why not go to Leonard? 6'4", the size and the athletic ability to go up and make the play, and Curtis Samuels led him perfectly on that ball.
Leonard with 7 catches today. That's one of the biggest right there. Here's Dick Butkus for the extra point. Ian Watts puts this one through. There we go. So it's 35-28, and Wyoming able to get it to the end zone, Mr. Norrie.
Yeah, nobody's happier than Ian Watts.
Except maybe Chris Fowler back in the studio.
Well, a quick update from St. Pete, where they're just underway, and almost a huge start for UCF. This is Quincy McDuffie. He's a true freshman, dangerous returner, off and running. It sets up UCF deep in Rutgers territory, but they can't cash in. It's the turnover as the linebacker, Damaso Munoz, for the Scarlet Knights, steps in front, makes the pick. That game already.